Hey, what's up?
And much more. And I'm also here with Milia Joseph Dennis because we understand that it's important that we also bring the Creole element into this. So let me say good morning to Cecil Joseph and Milia Joseph Dennis.
Well, good morning to you, to the listening public of DBS Radio. Today it's a solemn day for the Commonwealth of Dominica, the man who gave us independence 42 years and 10 months ago. Right here where we are standing at the Winter Park, what a better place that we can have the official viewing of the late Patrick Roland John, former Premier, I should say last Premier of Dominica and first Prime Minister of the Commonwealth of Dominica. And for us to say the Commonwealth of Dominica, it was through the hands and through the instruments of the man Patrick John giving us political independence. And today, as you rightly said, Ivona, it's a solemn day. A solemn day where Patrick John is actually saying his last farewell to us, to the public. Tomorrow we'll have the official burial of the man Patrick Roland John.
We can also say, o'clock. Cecil, that we have this live on Facebook, so people who are hearing us can also view us on Facebook.
And that's another product of DBS Radio in terms of really not just giving people audio, but give them an opportunity to see the event as it goes on during the course of the hours that we will be here. As I was saying earlier on, the program reads at 11 to 11:45. You have people from the Waterfront and Allied Workers Union. We know that he was part and parcel of this powerful union of the late mid-60s and also part of the Football Association. We all know that Patrick John brought us into CONCACAF and also into FIFA. We know that we played a number of qualifying games, and that's because of the ability of Patrick John through negotiation and to ensure that a small country like Dominica would be part and parcel of the World Cup, and also the Referee Association and that of the Dominica Cricket Association, and then the general public. Milia, bonjour.
Bonjour Cecil, bonjour Ivona, c'est un plaisir pour nous là encore, bien sûr. Alors, en manière qui est différent, oui, quand aujourd'hui nous la cour Windsor Park, quand cadavre Patrick John exposé, qui est bon, dominicain, et puis différentes organisations qui, et même Patrick John, n'y a pas pour jouer opportunité pour yo ça à ouais Caravli une dernière fois avant qui yo que tewe demain si c'est vrai enfin OK toujours espérer qui un monde comme Patrick John enfin monde là qui était vraiment voix pour badom une opportunité pour venir en pays qui en nation indépendant comme ça gouvernement a ka offert Patrick John en lettrement officiel ça qui prend place demain si délé mais comme on dit nous on wins avec la ici bon show moi ça dit une belle petit bon petit bon chalet en ville roseau mais quand nous là nous jaouais qui yo mené carave Patrick John déjà encore monde qui une opportunité pour voir qui exposé nous voyons qui carave là j'a posé enfin il y a dans casquette couvert et puis droit pour Dominique elle va laisser les pour monde ouais carave là vraiment qu'a penser qui yo qui ca ouvert carave là mais encore celle-ci le veille vous dans bagaille la mort c'est quelque chose qui nous tous savent qui est toujours oui vivons cette là la vie mais la réalité qui a venu qui a vraiment touché le ouais carave là qui a exposé ça le dernier moment où qu'il pour dire dede moun n'a pas que là encore et mon kan espéré comment famille même qui a senti là yo qu'il y a opportunité pour way et des fois moun qui y touché la vie yo moun qui travaille et puis différentes organisations qui tenaient pas pour jouer là que ka way caravli dernière fois aujourd'hui.
And in the background, we're hearing the music of NC Lanso. That's some music that Patrick John himself loved. And it is really good to note that when he came in, that was the actual music that was actually played. And so here today, Ivona, that we are here live. So far, I've only seen the only radio station here. It's important for us because when Dominica gained independence in 1978, we were actually here broadcasting to the rest of the world as to this moment. To the rest of the world, knowing who we were, what we were actually doing, the steps that we were taking. Today, I heard of this program from DBS Radio. Congratulations to the producers of that program. And we heard the princess talking of how a challenging period that it would have been for us. And she's very happy that she was able to represent the Queen to give us the instrument of independence.
Well, Cecil, it's important that you mentioned that DBS Radio is here because for us, this holds special significance. Obviously, when you go back to historical data on Dominica, you'll recognize that as a national broadcaster, DBS has an agenda to do things like that. Cecil, of course, it's a somber mood, but there's something that a state funeral affords, you know, some sort of pomp and circumstance, especially when you see the colors of the Dominica flag and you see the ushers, then the policemen, you know, carrying the casket. This signals a lot in terms of, you know, what we are here for.
It signifies for me something that you have deserved, something that you have done for your country. Any country of the world, you know, where there are actually official funerals, it says that that person actually left a mark, actually did something of significance to the country. And in Patrick John case, he has done so many different things. He was first in so many different things. And when you look at the life of Patrick John, I can state very clearly, in 1968, he was an MC. In the same Windsor Park, you know, emceeing and bringing in a number of Calypsonians, giving his jokes. And I wish that we could have played some of those words of Patrick
John. But these are things that we can still capture because obviously for posterity, we want to play productions like that, you know, in the years to come, you know, so we remember Patrick John. So we can always add, you know, to what we already have. You mentioned Patrick John, of course, as an MC. And on this very ground, Cecil, I can remember a long conversation you and I had. And it was then I realized that you may be a historian and you probably have to show your talent. But you mentioned that this area was called Cowtown in the past.
Yes.
Patrick John,
yes,
having been born in Roseau, coming from Kennedy Avenue, a Roseau boy, yes, he would have played a lot of sports.
And that
know,
is important, you know, knowing that his young life, you know, he came in Cowtown to really have part of his life shaped. And here today, he's going off of this earth. And the government of Dominica has seen it fit to really place him here. Out of the fact that he was able to give us political independence here, he played football for his teams. He played for the St. Mary's Academy in those days. He played for Combonia. And so Patrick John himself, you know, has had quite a long life at the Windsor Park. Now it's called the Windsor Park Sports Stadium. But Patrick John, if we remember that he had quite a lot of life in Roseau. In 1968 too, Ivona, that after he ran in 1965, became the mayor. In 68 again he ran, and himself, an active, had a challenging time with the Freedom Party, with that of Mr. Martin Sorrento and Star Lestrade, who and Sobers, I'm sorry, and Scobie, Edward Scobie, who eventually became mayor of the city after Patrick John. And it says quite a lot of the life of the man Patrick.
Okay, so we have just been told that the wife of Patrick John, Desiree John, is making her way now. I think she would be on wheelchair. She suffered an accident not too long ago. In fact, I'm seeing a wheelchair. So Desiree John, we will see her in a short while as she walks with her cane, taking slow steps to sit on the wheelchair. But Cecil, this says a lot. I mean, Cecil just being here for this is really history. Dominica, of course, celebrating its independence around that time. And when we look back to what happened in 1978, you'll realize that this man, who will be laid to rest tomorrow, was the one who brought us to statehood. But for people like Melia Joseph Dennis as well, a child of the 80s, I think, I'm a child of the 70s, so I too would have, known a lot, because I went to the Windsor Park when Dominica attained independence, so I can remember that like yesterday. But Melia Joseph Dennis, this definitely is a lesson for her as well. I'm sure, Melia, that you have learned a lot, even from the program that we had and what is happening here today.
Merci à vous, Eve. Je suis très heureuse de vous dire que c'est celle qui est d'accord, qui est une certaine chose qui ne m'a pas expérimenté pour les droits pour Dominique Tehose, première fois pour Dominique trouver l'indépendance, même ici, là, en Windsor Park. Enfin, il partait comme ça, modernisé comme ça. Mais comme je dis, il a fait un peu de sens pour nous, ouais, Caravli, exposé à en place qui, lui-même, Patrick John, était tellement grand pas pour jouer avec. Il fait tout simplement des choses ici, même. Quand nous dit nous kawe enfin madame Lipat parce que c'est madame Patrick John Desiree John en fait check qui passé était un accident qui a fait qu'il a roulé sur un fauteuil roulant bon matin hein. Mais
un jour avant un jour avant
Maui mort enfin ça a dit c'est Desiree et puis PJ qu'on nous connaît les tenir bonne relation ça c'est des monde qui ont témoigné pour bien long avec là où qu'a parlé côté nom avec femme monde qui maillé ça c'est peut-être qualité relation qui ont été les relation qui Desiree tenir et puis Patrick John enfin été si pour yon l'autre ça on savent qui Desiree était monde qui était là et puis Maui pas mais qui ça était force Maui enfin qu'on nous a dit était à boîte douette Maui ça c'est qualité relation qui était né
en même temps nous ne peut dire que ça Patrick John même maillé des fois il était né en premier madame il fait quatre enfants avec Paula Patricia Junior John c'est Junior John avec Herphilia il fait quatre avec premier madame lui avec mon ne peut savoir ça après ça avant ça il était né Renick John c'est premier enfant avec Renick John toujours là avec papa.
But to talk about Patrick John is to talk about the political landscape of Dominica. In fact, to look at the life of PJ, as he was affectionately known, is to look at the historical events, in the Caribbean island, and put in proper context his significant contribution to trade unionism, to sports as well, specifically football, and generally the impact, on the public, of the nation. So to talk about Patrick John is to talk about a lot where it concerns Dominica.
And even when we talk about Patrick John and the region, people like Forbes Burnham, would play an important role in the life of Patrick John.
At one time,
when I was growing up, people tend to think that Patrick John was going to eliminate that of the man Forbes Burnham, who at the time, many people of the Caribbean did not understand his philosophy and his ideas. And Patrick John would have taken the idea. Even if it was from Dame Eugenia Charles, when she decided that we should have a president because he felt that she was trying to stall the election, he decided that, okay, if you think you would have a president, he decided that, yes, we are going to go with the idea of a president. So the first country of the Caribbean with a president was that of Forbes Burnham. Dominica followed suit, and the third one is now Trinidad and Tobago, Republic of Trinidad and Tobago. And Dominica was the second suit in terms of having a president. So, yes, Patrick John, with people like even Milton Cato from St. Vincent, were very close. Even that of John Compton in St. Lucia. At the time, they were the figures with that of Veerbird in the region. So Veerbird, Patrick John, Milton Cato, John Compton, and Forbes Burnham in those days. The father, really, to all of them, was that of Eric Williams. Robert Batchelor himself in St. Kitts was also an important one in the life of all of those people in the region.
Oh yes, these were political forces. I mean, they really shaped the Caribbean, the political landscape in the Caribbean. And these gentlemen were forces to reckon with. I think Sir John Compton, of course, he passed, I think it was 2007, was it?
2007, yes, when after he brought his party into power.
Cato would have passed, I think, in 1997.
That's correct.
So, yes. But, you know, so that is why we are, it's on this premise that we are here. Not only for the viewing of the body, but we see this as very significant. Because what we want to bring as well is some, you know, of the historical data. As we tie it in.
And if memory serves me right, all of those great leaders of the region at that time, Patrick John was the last of them all. And Patrick is now going to meet his friends and those other great leaders of the region in those days. The Indigenous Charters have gone a long time ago, in 2005, I think they're about. And so we know that Patrick John has played an important role in Dominica's politics. We must say, though, to Ivona, in terms of Patrick John, when he entered the legislation, in the 1970, the House of Assembly of 1970, they had the first election in 1970 under the associated statehood, because we know that 1st of March of 1967 we became an associated statehood, and so Patrick John was part and parcel of the Liberal Labour Party. Let us not talk about the Dominican Labour Party. There's a difference at the time of the Dominican Labour Party and that of the Liberal Labour Party. Liberal Labour Party ran, won 8 seats. The Dominican Labour Party won 1, and the Dominican Freedom Party won 2. That made it a number of 11 seats in 1970. I just want to ensure that has been said.
Oh, definitely, Cecil. And then, of course, if we have to go further down the lane, we'd realise that 1978, November 3, was really a defining moment for Dominica when we attained statehood, political independence, and Patrick John, of course, was at the forefront of this. He would have signed the declaration, the independence declaration in Salisbury. And that really, you know, put Dominica on a different trajectory, because at that time, we were an independent nation.
But before Patrick John became premier of Dominica, we would have known of the work that he did with that of Mr. E.O. Libla. And so E.O. Libla had quite a lot of confidence in Patrick John. And by virtue of this, E.O. Libla, in every opportunity given to him, would have given him to be a minister of somewhat in his cabinet. I remember Patrick John was saying to me sometime in the early days, when he was actually giving us the coaching of public speaking, he made mention to us in reference to he being the shortest minister ever in the history of Dominica for 2 days, when he was given the ministry of
the shortest in terms of his what? His stint, right?
The shortest minister in the history of Dominica.
Well, he was short. He was short. So I was
when I explain that, you'll understand that in 1970, when he was given the Ministry of Education and Health, the public officers of both the doctors and the teachers, the very first day that he was given that position, wrote to the Premier then, E.O. Libla, and said to him that they did not want Patrick John. They were forceful against the fact of having Patrick John as their minister for education.
Not to interrupt you, but as you speak, I just see this guy come with this frame.
Yes, picture.
Picture of Patrick John, you know. And you, a lot of people remember him like that, because, you know, he used to love this jacket.
Shirt jacks,
in fact. You know, and his trousers, you know, and always had his glasses or his shades at times. So I just had to make note of this. Yeah. So this has been placed now on the easel.
And as I was saying before Miller takes over, that at that time, Patrick John, as I said, was the shortest of them, 2 days. And then he was moved to be Minister of Communication and Works. And while being Minister of Communication and Works, you know, here goes Libla again doing a reshuffling of his cabinet, and gave Patrick John another ministry. So Patrick John found himself, you know, in almost every ministry, served in almost every ministry.
I think he did Communications and Works.
He did Communications and Works. He did Home Affairs. Mm-hmm. He did Minister of Finance. He did Minister of Agriculture. Yeah. You know, so he had, for me, quite a lot. in terms of serving Dominica. So when we talk about a man who really served Dominica, you could say Patrick John would be high up on that of that order.
Was there a lot of shuffling done in those days? And even as you answer that, what about gerrymandering? Did we see a lot of that in those days?
We didn't see quite a lot of shuffling there. I think there's about in the days of Libla, there was one period when he did some reshuffling of his cabinet, and when he placed Patrick John into a particular ministry. And then we saw Patrick John himself did some shuffling when that of he fired Minister of Agriculture, Minister Etienne. In reference to gerrymandering, there was something that they placed very nice, and they call it the electoral boundary or the constitutional boundaries, and they set up what is called the Constitutional Boundaries Commission. And so in 1969, you would have seen some 11 constituencies. In 1970's election, there was 11 constituencies in Dominica. And when Patrick John came in as premier, he took the constitution and created what was called the boundaries of commission, and then had 11 constituencies. At the time when Patrick John ran for election, the very first time he ran for election, he ran the Roseau Northern seat. It was called the Roseau Northern seat. And when he ran in 1975, the second time, he then called it the Goodwill constituency. And we saw in 1980-85, thereabout, we then saw the change of the name to the Roseau North constituency.
To say that, Cecil, again, I see the wife of Patrick John, Desiree John, being driven closer to the casket. So we will see the casket now being opened, so she can have the final viewing. So the casket is now being opened. Very somber mood now. Soothing music being played in the background. And Desiree now is being helped to come off the wheelchair so she can look at her husband.
For me, Ivona, it's a very sad moment.
It is. There's no
knowing in my growing up, you know, how much I was part of the whole movement of Patrick John, how much I was, you know, involved in the movement of Patrick John. And to see his casket now open and to have a viewing of him, it's really
sting,
a sad moment.
It
stings.
It reminds you of the sting of death.
Yes.
And it's in these times that you begin to think of your own mortality, you know, when in situations like that. So she's going closer now to this casket to get a clear view. When he died on the 6th of July. Today, of course, is the 28th of October, of September.
September.
So he has been in the morgue for a while. So she's looking now, dressed in black and her black hat. Of course, very evident that she suffered a foot injury on her right leg in the ankle area. So Desiree looks on at her husband, former Prime Minister of Dominica, the first Prime Minister of Dominica. He was also a Premier, Patrick Roland John, affectionately known as PG.
I tried to take a peep as to what he was actually dressed in. I'm going to try to find out.
You're like very brave. I don't really like to look at dead bodies.
I think it looks like something like that of represent as a warden of the Anglican Church.
He was very much involved. Very much involved, Cecil, in church, very much involved.
So I will ask him eventually, mm-hmm. what the
Desiree is going back to her seat. Yes, Desiree is going back to her seat.
Yes.
And being held, of course, by one of the close friends of Patrick John, Simeon Joseph.
Yes.
And
it's not an easy moment,
it
know,
is
for,
not.
For any wife who not. Has been together with her husband for 40 years.
Yes, sir.
So
if you're just tuning in,
two children, you know,
let's just remind people, if you're just tuning in, we are at the Windsor Park Stadium for the public viewing of the late Patrick John. Windsor Park being also used as a vaccination center and a testing center as well for the COVID-19 virus. So a lot is happening here as we speak. But it's well organized.
Can you imagine in the days when Patrick John took power that he actually had power during the oil crisis? And now, you know, a few years later.
So these are the things that we want to talk about.
Many years later, you know, we are actually witnessing.
But Milia, I think it would be important that Milia as well explains what is happening. Milia, of course, we see Desiree being driven back to her seat.
I mean, I've observed this. avant. Pour même ça que regarder sur télévision, mais ça que regarder YouTube et Facebook. Ça c'est un moment et qui ça c'est un moment pour nous-mêmes réfléchir. Ça c'est autant qui vous a dit, vous n'avez pas de l'air, ça arrive avec nous, ça doit être exposé aussi. Mais encore en situation en partie, John, pour nous dire. Personne en les thèmes officiels comme ça. Puis là où
garder. State funeral.
State funeral. Ça fait ça considérer. Il fait toute bagaille, tout aspect à la société, où ça n'imagine que ça c'est quelque chose qui est nécessaire pour cette étape. Et je dis,
And you see, Emilio, what's also important, sorry to really cut you, but I think that's very significant before it leaves me. He brought Dominica into political independence, and the flag of Dominica was actually had to be endorsed by his cabinet. And today, you know, he's saying goodbye to us, and that flag that he endorsed is still here today, you know, showing him out, you know, into this life.
Eh bien, c'est ça, vous savez. Ça se lève, vous na. Par là, c'est on peut le notant code Patrick Roland John PJ. Après, avec un venir en l'esprit, c'est politique. Tout le monde est déportant. Ça avec grand pas qui jouait pour Dominic. Ça tapait déportant. Ça quelque chose qui nous a joué quand on a des années et puis aujourd'hui, nous voulons apprécier l'effort qu'il fait, qui nous lâche ça quand il joue. Réparance nous aujourd'hui, hein?
Mais nous avons parlé, donc c'est la daughter, first daughter of Patrick John, Patricia Richards. She's Patricia John Richards.
This is very sad, you know.
Yes, to watch your dad, you know. And she was very close with her father, I remember, you know.
For a moment, I'm really feeling this thing, yes. You know, especially when the children, you know, come to pay their last respects. It is not easy.
And it's good that, you know, she's also touching him, and I'm sure she's speaking with her father, because that's how they were, you know. She always had conversation with her father, and you can see she's actually trembling there, and her first son with her husband, I'm sorry, with her wife, with his wife, Mary John, you know, good orator himself, a good writer, is staring onto his father, and it says quite a lot of, you know, Mary. And now you have Paula. Paula is his last daughter.
Is it the last?
The last daughter with his wife. That's
with his wife. His first wife. His first wife. Okay.
That's Paula John, Jacques, and you know. So it's really a moment.
Wow. And why is this going on? We hear Whitney Houston in the background singing "I Will Always Love You." You know, a very telling song as well. And
that's his grandchildren.
Creates that ambience. So we see his grandchildren coming now. This is definitely, you know, a heartbreaking moment.
Well, this one here is his great-granddaughter. The first one is his great-granddaughter.
They're dressed in black.
Yes. It's not a good moment for them, I can imagine. Especially his granddaughter, Naomi, you know, so very close with her granddad.
Oh,
and she's going to be crying, I can guarantee.
She has started in
practice. She has already started. I told you. She was very, very, and she's one of the person who has the features of Patrick John. Mm-hmm. You know, the first
shorty.
She is the daughter of Renick John, you know, and have her two daughters, you know, so that she's in the middle, and his other great granddaughter. Here you can see the witnessing of it. She's going to touch her grandfather. I know they would have done that because they're very close.
Yeah. There's a finality about death that strikes you hard, you know, Cecil.
Yes.
And especially when you are at the point where you are viewing, you know, your loved ones, so you can really rip your heart apart. And I really feel for them, but of course they have to move on. This happens, you know, it is a commitment, and it is it's something that we all must go through.
Yes.
We have to die. We just have to die, all of us.
Yes.
But we continue to broadcast from the Windsor Park Stadium.
And there's another granddaughter.
Yes.
Daughter of, again, Renick John.
Yes. And Cecil, who is this gentleman?
That's Renick John.
Oh, yes.
That's Renick John.
Sometimes when people have mass.
That's his first daughter. Sorry, his first son.
First son, yes.
That's his first son, you know, Renick John. I know that would be a sad moment for Renick, because I remembered when Patrick became premier, that Renick himself played a great role in going above, because we have what is called the Young Democrats, and Renick was part of the Young Democrats in those days, and he was one of the young boys at that time, who would have gone wrong with his father, And myself and Simeon Joseph and a few of us, you know, Uma Ostri, Philorina Woodman Paul, would have gone around with him around the country to set up what is called the Labour Youth Organization.
Oh, yeah. So Cecil, can you make out who is coming now?
I'm trying to make out that person. Not so
there's
sure.
And it's going well. It's going smoothly. Well, yes. Next will be Frank Georges. This gentleman who is at the front right now, Cecil.
He's a former fire officer. Okay. That's the son of the guy who's what do you call him? Coppell.
Okay.
That's Mr. Coppell.
Oh, okay. All right. Okay.
Right here. You know?
And we see waiting next is Franklin Georges, historian.
Well, not just Pan-Africanist. Not just Pan-Africanist. He was also the mayor of Walton Forest in England.
Yes, yes. And he always reminds us that he played that role.
I remember.
So he comes now dressed in white, all in white. I tell you, a nice white cap, white trousers, white top, kind of a dashiki style.
Yes.
White, plain white, and his white shoes and his cane. Franklin Georges has done a lot in terms of educating us about our history.
Yes.
And it's his turn now to say farewell to a good friend.
He's just done that.
Parlant de histoire, nous pouvons imaginer que Mr. Georges Kelly, vous savez, quand la vie Patrick John, nous allons vous parler de histoire. Il y a un seul monde qui a vraiment poussé pour histoire. Pas seulement monde, mais histoire monde à Kawaii. C'est quelque chose qui est bien important avec Mr. Georges Kelly, qui est bien éduqué en histoire monde.
I really like that because especially now as we're in the school season again in September, of course it's not usual times. It would be interesting for a history subject just to have like a Patrick John Day, you know, something like that, you know, and ask students to do something.
This young lady, I know her, she's from the Gotha area.
Okay. And when you say Gotha, you have to think of Patrick John.
And you must think of Patrick John, you know, because Gotha, for many persons, you may not have known that The Gotha area was actually made for a public cemetery.
Oh yes, that's
right. And it took Patrick John, when that was done, a man from the Gotha area, to get in, build a house, and Patrick John eventually opened up the area.
Cecil, ever thought of documenting some of the things that you know? I think you're very good at remembering things and people. I mean, la cool discoveries, you know, on a Sunday, you know, really brought out the talent and your ability to remember. So I think that it's a good thing if you document a lot
of things. So many people may not know that the Gotha area was actually earmarked for a cemetery. You know?
Yes, you told me that.
And it took Patrick John when one man, Mr. McDowell, decided that he was going to build a small shack in the area. And then many other persons went to Patrick John, and then he then endorsed the area. And today, you can see what the area is like. And that's why, as I said to you yesterday, a number of persons in that area felt very committed to him. That's why even in the building of the houses in Bath Estate, a number of persons from the Bath Estate area.
This Baptist guy is coming up.
Gordon Baptist. Yes. Gordon Baptist and Patrick John's father. Sorry. The father of Gordon Baptist and Patrick John were very close buddies. As a matter of fact, in 1975, Gordon's father ran for the Dominican Labour Party when he lost by some 40 votes against Demi Junior Charles in 1975. When
who is coming
Charles
next,
run,
Cecil? That is, Cecil, you have so much history. I think we need an hour to sit.
That is, I think, he just passed.
Okay,
Mr.
Member
Johnson,
of the task force? Okay.
Task force,
all right.
Of the task force.
Okay.
And I was saying that Patrick John and the father of Gordon, they went a long way, played football together. They were buddies, they were friends. And so Patrick John at the time, Mr. Baptist at the city council, Patrick himself, remember, was the mayor of the city in 1965, would have seen the ability of the man, Mr. Baptist, Tom Baptist. And so Tom Baptist ran for the Dominican Labour Party in 1975, lost against Demi Junior Charles, a well-fought fight between the both of them.
I mean, oui, on call and toujours vu histoire, Cécile. Nous avons vraiment apprécié. Qui ou la journée pour nous ça oui éduquer nous on fait pour ça qu'il faut qu'on éduquer pour éduquer nous contre toutes ces bagages là et ben quoi ils vont dire il y a raison pour peut-être que ouais on déchire blanc soupe ça c'est pas c'est ça j'ai ça mon mémoire qui il n'y a pas ces bagages mémoire
les soupes là
non pas ni les soupes et ben nous quand même après ces appuis encore c'est vraiment ça là c'est quelque chose qui ces bagages qui supposé sortir. Il s'est posé sur le mot plus doux. Oui, nous là, nous là, papa de Côte-Patrick John. Mais quand Ivona m'a dit qu'elle allait à faire l'école, vous savez, en ce qu'on joue, nous ça.
And even when Patrick John himself became, when he got himself involved in politics in 1970, I remember he was saying to us at a discussion that his mother was never pleased for him to get himself involved.
Yes, you
in
told
politics.
Me that yesterday, and I heard it on the program as well, that his mother was never
pleased.
Yes.
And they did not speak for a number of years, you know, but the day that he was actually. Was going to be selected as the leader of the party. The mother actually called him and told him that he should accept the position given to him, and if he wins, that she assured him that he should always look out for the ordinary. Do not victimize. Do not press people. Look for the ordinary people. And so, unfortunately, after he was inaugurated as the leader of the party, a week later. And thinking about it, you know, when the Labour Party, when the Liberal Labour Party was going through its period of turbulence, E.O. Liberal, and I heard it this morning, E.O. Liberal actually stayed in Vickers and allowed Patrick to continue doing what he has to do, sitting in as acting Prime Minister.
Cecil, I'm just saying, Franklin George is bringing another portrait of the late Patrick John, so I guess that was on his vehicle. He went for it.
Give to the wife of Patrick,
yes.
And that's important.
It is.
And as I was saying earlier, that so while they were going through this turbulence, E.O. Liberal would come to cabinet.
Yes, but Cecil, it's very interesting that you're mentioning this as well, because the 70s was a tumultuous period for Dominica.
Oh, yes.
We know the Dread Act in 1974. We know what happened in 1979. Even before that, so I'm talking about the 70s.
Even before the Dread
Act. Yes, a lot was happening at that time.
We would have known, you know, under Liberal that that there are a few individuals in Roseau who was not very in favor of the Liberal's leadership and created a stir in Parliament. And so, you know, really and truly, Patrick John in 1970 saw all of these things,
mm-hmm.
and himself would have been gain of himself in event, you mm-hmm. know. And so Patrick, you know, has done quite a lot in the landscape of politics in Dominica, and in 1974 when he became the leader of the Liberal Labour Party, I should say. Let us distinguish that, because at that time the Liberal Labour Party had the symbol, the hat. So it was not symbol, the shoe. The Dominica Labour Party had the symbol, the shoe. And so we saw in 1975 when Patrick ran, he then brought the party together and then captured the shoe as the political symbol of the Dominica Labour Party. So in 1975, we can see we saw the emergence of the Labour, the Liberal Labour Party and the Dominica Labour Party together. Because as I said, in 1970, the Liberal Labour Party won 8 seats, to include that of Patrick John. He ran against a giant of the Dominica Labour Party at the time, who was Nan Ducray. And as he always said to us, that it was very difficult for him, he believed, that to win a person like Nan Ducray. But the work that he had already done among the ordinary folks, especially when you were at the Waterford Ally Workers Union, it was important at that time.
All right, Cecil, as you speak, we see more people coming, and this is well organized. I mean, there's a special area cordoned off. There's an exit to go to see the body, view it, and then there's an entrance, in fact, to go view the body, and then there's an exit when you leave. So we see more people coming, and Bridge Over Troubled Water being played right now, very somber mood. The decoration, not too much, a lot of there's flowers, you know, and plants, you know, but more green and white. You see the different shades of green, you know, and the casket, of course, in the middle of this section that is really cordoned off for this purpose. So we have ushers here as well, you know, as they guide the viewers. So we see a few more people coming. Can make Nairia, I understood, is coming. very flamboyant Nairi, of course, and his dressing really tells who he is, you know, and Aisha as well. So very soon they are going to view the
so
body.
To apologize early on, so there was someone who looked so much like Nairi.
Yes, I was wondering, because I did not
so
say anything,
much
but
like
I know
Nairi.
When people have masks, I can't really make them up, but I know that's not Nairi.
Yes.
And I know Nairi is very flamboyant.
Yes.
His dressing, so I was wondering what is happening.
That might be the difference, you know.
And I'm not sure if you saw him, Cecil.
No, I haven't seen him.
If you see his dressing,
oh, yes, I'm seeing him now, yes. Oh,
that's
Nairi. Like a real king,
yes.
You know, that's
yes.
Nairi. He would have come with all
very
of his gold.
Very dapper looking,
yes.
I must say.
And here it is, Nairi and his sister,
yes,
Aisha.
And granddaughter,
daughter, and daughter of Naisha.
No, that's
daughter.
Right. Daughter of,
oh, daughter,
Nairi.
No, daughter of Nairi.
Yes, yes.
This mask thing is sometimes can put
yeah,
us off, you know.
You know? Bamboozles me.
Ever para Ivo, ça c'est de capable mo réaliser qui Ivo na tellement mon confort. Confort en sens là qui il la carte un peu toute information qui c'est la capotiver. Nous nous capoiser ça. Nous capoiser ça aussi. Mais check si
even before you ask the question. Cecil and history. So Cecil and I sat down in my office yesterday for more than an hour and we were just talking, you know, about, you know, things. Patrick John, you know, when you talk about Patrick John, you know, it goes on to so many other things. But it's interesting that you made that point, Amelia, but you were going to ask a question.
Oui, check si on se Cecil le autant tout toute histoire ça là avec Patrick John. Check si on se you know more no camera angle what if si. Elle va mentionner que maman Patrick John premier maman parti l'aller aller direction ça là. Mais ça coûte si il t'écouter maman. What if?
You see, the power of God is what's matters. And you remember when, I think in the program, I heard the asking the question about when he was taken off from office. He said that was God's will. Mm-hmm. So at the end, I take it to mean that it was God's will because maybe we would not have had, we would not have had the National Bank. Because at that time, you know, mm-hmm. Patrick John was very strong of ensuring that the ordinary people that his mother told him that he should take charge of, you know, we would have maybe have the National
and maybe
Bank.
Maybe independence would have come, and yes, but
yes,
maybe not.
But not at that time.
Yeah, long
you know?
After.
Yeah. Maybe the Deepwater Harbor would not have been there, you know. Mm-hmm. Maybe the Social Security would not have been there.
Yeah.
So the point is, God has a particular space for you in this world.
And when he calls on you, you have to listen.
And
to
when he calls on you,
yeah.
I mean,
the universe has a way, you know, of telling you things, and you just have to listen. And Patrick John listened to that call. And
that was of great importance, you know. And so, as I was saying to you, Ivona, so we saw the life of Patrick John, a flamboyant one in the days of he being involved in politics, you know. He was loved by so many different class. Different people, but there was always a struggle between himself and the upper class, you know, because as I've said to you, I'm not so sure because of the fact that when he ran against Dame Eugenia Charles in 1970 in the Rosso Northern constituency, that he won over that of Dame Eugenia Charles and won handsomely. And so you find that Dame Eugenia Charles, a lawyer, a popular figure in Dominica at the time.
So Cecil, even before, just stick up in there, we're just looking at this gentleman who
Hostel.
Just came from. Okay, all
Hostel
right.
Ansem.
Hostel Ansem.
Who is a trustee at the time of Patrick John
okay.
As the head of the party. Hostel himself was a trustee of the Dominican Labour Party and still a trustee of the Dominican Labour Party as we speak. Oh no, that is the associate. He looks so much like Hostel. That is Glenn Etienne.
Oh, I was wondering. Hey, Cecil, I tell you.
Glenn Etienne. Oh my God. I mean,
Cecil,
the mask can do so much. He looks so much like Hostel and walks so much like Hostel, but sorry to our listeners, that's Glenn Etienne.
President of the Football Association,
and
of course.
His other, this
is Ken George.
Ken George.
Who cannot make
because
on Ken
George,
even if he has a mask on?
And for sure, the gallery.
Yes, the gallery, Ericsson, the gallery as well. So the Dominica Football Association were represented, of
is
course,
the secretary
from
the
Dominica
Football
Association. Yes, I'm trying to remember her name. I think she was. She got the position not too long ago, but it's nice that the DFA is well represented and they're wearing their masks. Which has the DFA logo on it, and it's written DFA as well.
And what is beautiful about that is what he has done for the Dominica Football Association.
Oh, Cecil, if we have to talk about football and Patrick John, it will take a whole day. Gerald George as well is here, of course.
That's Patrick John,
when you talk about football, the Dominica Football House, and his, you know, his affiliation with Jack Warner, the former vice president of FIFA, you know, and so much he has done for Dominica in terms of bringing us out there, you know, in CONCACAF, you know, in
And he was placed in the Hall of Fame of CONCACAF. That yes, says quite a lot about Patrick was. John, you know.
Oh yes.
And the impression that he must have created in the minds of so many representatives of
CONCACAF. We see Carlisle John Baptist as well. Carrying out his duties as a cameraman and a journalist as well, but Carlisle would have been very close to football as well, and close to Patrick John too. So as we speak now, the music continues like a bridge over troubled water. And people are viewing very orderly, very orderly. This is going on nicely. And I see one of the, Cecil, I'm trying to make out this guy. I think he's...
It's Andre.
Right, Andre.
Yes.
He works on the field.
On the field, on yes. The field, marker yes. Of the a field, football
yes,
marker.
Right,
you know?
Right. So yes.
That's Andre. And another, the driver of the Football Association.
Right. I'm trying to remember.
Samuel. Martin Samuel.
Yes, yes. Martin.
And you know, the whole... Yeah. Body of the Football Association is actually here, and that is
so. That's
me,
Regina Walsh.
That's
yes,
Regina
so?
Walsh.
Yes.
Yes, Regina Walsh. You know, for me, that's a proud moment. I really love that. You know,
it is
to
it
see
is.
The entire executive members of the Football Association. Actually
and it's
there.
Really good that we have this large expanse of land that mm-hmm. we can call another section. You know, mm-hmm. and have you know an event like that, Cecil. Mm-hmm. And not just because it's a large expanse, but because of the historical significance that it holds. The Windsor Park Sports Stadium. So, Cecil, as we speak now, more people coming. Cecil, I like this.
I'm seeing a lady from Bath Estate.
I like what is happening. Yes.
And she would have been one of the persons who would have received the halls from Patrick John in
the
those
people.
Days of the mid-70s.
These are the people that really
These are
feel
the
it.
People that really
You remember
feel
people like Sasai.
Sasai.
Sirene Yuti.
I wonder if Sasai would be able to come here today. If, she, oh, if Sasai comes here, yeah. She's going to break down.
Yes, yes. I even understand. Remember my grandmother who died yes. in 1983, and she yes. was at the time cleaning the botanic gardens. You know, she was one of the people, you know, raking, you know, the grass. And all of that, you know,
yes.
and people like that, Patrick John, you know, yes. they would talk about Patrick John. It's like he was, you know, something else. And so
I can
when
see Audrey just shaking her head, you know,
yes.
and I get goosebumps just watching Audrey. You know, just watching, staring.
And this lady,
she's from River Street.
River Street.
Yes, I'm trying to always remember her name. You know?
Is it River Street or Hillsborough Street? River Street.
River
she
Street.
Looks like a lady
River
from.
Street,
oh, okay,
yeah.
All right.
I know her very, 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 very well. She all now right. lives, I think, in Pottersville.
All right.
And so we see the public is now actually coming in. There's a lady I know, Rita.
Yes.
She too was a follower as a young girl mm-hmm. With the Dominican Labour Party, Rita. This one, I'm not so sure who she is. She's looking on, staring. She's
is there someone you do not know, Cecil? You just cannot recognize at the time.
You just can't recognize right. at the time.
Okay.
You know?
And, so they are coming one by one to
yes,
view.
The public.
Of course, we have to continue to exercise protocols. Mm-hmm. We are in this period when COVID-19 is...
This young man, I remember as a young man. This junk man, I remember
who is
as a young man.
The casket
with a taxi, yes, a taxi
okay.
driver. I'm sure that you would have transported Patrick John quite a number of times. You know, in those days, there was no flair of having a state car and
all
this
right.
kind of thing. You know,
mm-hmm.
so I remember this guy. You know, a taxi driver. This is a young lady.
Yeah,
she's from the Marigot area for sure. She lives in town now. I'm staying on to Patrick.
Mm-hmm. Patrick John, of course, was an advocate for the underprivileged, for
yes.
the ordinary man.
Ordinary.
He received a lot of criticism from the elite class, from the bourgeoisie, but he was not daunted in his task. He felt that he had something extra to do, not just as a prime minister.
And it's amazing, you know, just to our west where we are standing, you know.
Oh, Cecil, here comes a good song. You know, that's one of
yes.
my favorites.
That's one of my favorites by Grant
That was my favorite for last year. So sorry to interrupt you. As I say that, I see Curtis Mafia as well. But Cecil is making a good point. Go ahead.
And we're talking about the National Bank, you know. The National Bank was built under the stewardship of Patrick. This building here, the government headquarters,
yes, yes.
was built while Patrick John himself, well, I should say Libla, you know, in the 60s.
But this area, built. Cecil, this area has a lot of historical significance.
Very, very much.
A lot happened, you know, wrong that square.
From where if you look up to the
I
north.
I think Patrick Don have built some houses somewhere
so
up
this,
there, Cecil?
Right here, you'll see those houses right there.
And there's
in
a good
Lower Murphy's Lane. Lower Murphy's Lane.
Okay.
There was like 50 steps, so there was there's a lot of
yes,
bushes,
yes.
you know.
I can remember
in the area.
Passing on that step every day when my
and
grandmother was at hospital.
Sometimes if you're playing football from Goodwill, you have to cross the river. No, that's no more.
Yeah.
You know, so this Lower Murphy's house is built by Patrick, the Davids, Griffith family, all of these people. Bacow,
so we say Bacow, Lady
Bacow. She came from viewing the body of
yes.
Patrick, you know. She's from Pottersville.
Yes.
So that would have said to you
I
that
mean,
Patrick
is,
John would have represented.
She's originally from Laplin.
She's originally from Laplin, but okay. she lived in Pottersville, you
all
know.
Right.
And here it is, you know, she came and to have a nice view of the man Patrick John. So as you were talking about the constituency and the rules of Northern at that time, you would have seen those Lower Murphy's houses being built by Patrick. And so, you know, he created that mark among some people. So some people, you know, even when he was not prime minister, they still gave him a great level of respect.
Cecil, and I kind of regret, because what I should have done was to prepare my daughters to come for this. And I did not do that. And as a parent, I feel regret, because this is history. Mm-hmm. They were not there in 1978. But this is history. And I really wish that, you know, parents can take advantage of this opportunity.
But you see, as you're saying about this is history, this forecourt now is known as the Winter Park Forecourt. But we would know that right here would be the Rosa Girls School, actually where Patrick is actually.
There was a health center there as well. I remember coming to get my injection.
There was a health center north from where Patrick Coffin is. There was this health center right where you see.
Yeah, I can remember going up the steps. I think it was a wooden building. And
it was a wooden building.
Bumps and lice and rubella. Right. You had to go and get
white, a white building, right across the building. You would have this gutter that you'd cross and then come to the Rosa Girls School. So we have Patrick John bodies laid. And the Rosa Girls School is actually there. You can see that gate right here. That gate where the entrance was to enter into the Rosa Girls School.
I remember that area, you know? Because I live not too far
and
from
And just
there.
A little south of that gate, you would have had the trucks of the Rosa Town Council, at the time it was called, being parked to do their daily chores. And you would have had the gate, as you can see, it's still there presently, to enter the Winter Park. The Winter Park for sports.
Really, a lot of history. I tell you.
Moi, rappelez ces histoires à la piste. Attends, moi quand même. C'était avec Winter Park déjà là.
And you too, Melia. You are very good at remembering things. So you're going to remember this for many years.
Ah, mais oui. Mais attends, moi Winter Park avait mon coin Sifokol. Sifokol,
c'est pas des yachts.
C'était pas des yachts. C'est un temps, moi. Mais c'est bon bagage. Malheureusement,
just sorry, Melia. This young lady, her father herself was. Part and parcel of Patrick John, her father was Mr. Donald Pond, the daughter of Donald Pond.
Oh, okay, all right.
You know, the daughter of Donald Pond.
Yes.
She just from viewing the body. Yes. I'm sure she did that for her father too.
Okay, yes.
Because her father's not too
well these days, you know? Yes.
So, yes, Mila, you were saying.
Yes. So, Mila, you were making a very interesting point when we interrupted you.
Oui, Mordeca dit, vous savez, il était bien. Je ne sais pas comment toujours, quand toujours m'a repoussé pour nous avoir un museum. On comprend un musée, Cécile, pour là, nous avons parlé de l'histoire. On peut le monter que les cachets pour connecter et puis bagay qu'on porte, photo, bagay comme ça. Et là, nous parlons de au place comme ça, la Yohose doit pour Dominique pour première fois pour indépendance. Mon capot c'est été ni mon con là, Cécile,
avec
photo était sorti pour voir ces bagages là, pour voir à voir action Dominique. Puis Dominique c'est bien content pour voir Dominique taper indépendance après bon une année à bas à l'Angleterre. Et là, montant toutes ces bagages là, on parle de Rose Girls School, on parle de Health Center, on parle de toutes ces bagages là qui étaient là. Là, nous devons là, j'aurais à pour nous a dit Patrick John ça c'est quelque chose qui coûte toujours essayer puis c'est un moment exceptionnel.
I'm sure Ivona, where Patrick John is, that's where the entrance of the Rosa Girls School would have been.
Yes, and almost to the end, you have to get it right. I know you.
And almost to the end of where the head of Patrick John would have been, would have been class 3A.
We
I'm almost sure. If anyone comes here,
if I know you well enough, Cecil, you will remember exactly where you were sitting as well.
I remember that I was a troublesome guy in 3A. So I'm sure that if memory serves me right, if anyone comes here and they went to Rosa Girls School together with me, or ever went to Rosa Girls School, I'm sure that they would tell me I'm correct, you know? Yeah. And right there, we used to have a guy called Buzai, you know? Buzai, who was from the CUM Church, you know? Mm-hmm. Who lived where you see, right where you see this pole and the bleachers are.
Okay.
Buzai would have lived there, you know?
Okay.
Behind
even
the
as
health
you
center.
Mentioned Buzai, Cecil, what also came to mind is that we had a lot of characters in Rosa in particular. Of course, they have passed, but they adored Patrick John. So remember people like Marco?
Yes. Marco lived just along there on Hillsborough Street.
You know, and some of the other, you know, characters at that time, they would be shouting PJ, PJ, PJ. So, you know, they were very close to their leader.
But it's strange, though, that at that time, while Marco loved Patrick John, I don't think the family of Marco was a supporter of Patrick John. Because at the time, the Freedom Party was really a force to be reckoned with in Rosa Central in the 70s. You know?
If you're just tuning in, let us just welcome you at the Winter Park Stadium, bringing you live the viewing of the body of the late Patrick John. He will be laid to rest tomorrow. And of course, DBS Radio bringing this live to you, because for us, this is very, very important. This is part of our agenda. This is who we are. at DBS Radio, we see these events as very, very, very significant, not just for posterity, but we realize that the onus is on us, the national radio station, to do such things. And it is on this premise that we are here, and we are well pleased.
I would really like to really outline to people in 1970 when Patrick John ran the election. As I said, he ran for the Roseau Northern constituency. He won for the Liberal Labour Party. The Roseau Southern was won by Roland Oliver Amor. He was a member of the Liberal Labour Party. Also the West, Egbert John Shillingford, again to won for the Liberal Labour Party. The Northern Western was won by Edward Oliver Libla, at the time Premier, Liberal Labour Party. The Southwestern, Anthony Moyes, the Dominican Freedom Party. The Eastern, Henkel Lockingham Christian, the Liberal Labour Party. The Northern East, Will Strathmore Stevens.
Cecil has everything on his exercise book. Is this a Kanpad exercise book, Cecil?
Yes, a Kanpad. Yes, all right. And the Southeastern, Thomas Etienne, the Liberal Labour Party. The North was won by John Livingstone Royer, the Liberal Labour Party. And Libla, the John Livingstone Royer was from Vickers. I knew that man very
history
well.
Class from as a matter
of fact, he was the grandfather of Colin Roy. Okay. I would have known him.
Yes,
you know,
yes.
Portsmouth was won by Earl Andrew Leslie, the Liberal Labour Party, and the Southern by Ralph Stanley Fidel, the Dominican Freedom Party.
Wow, wow, wow! I tell you, John Patrick John really embodied the strength of the nation and the determination to realize that shift towards political independence, and that was the best thing for us at the time.
And at that time, the Freedom Party was just 2 years old because they moved from the DUPP, the Dominica United Progressive Party, to the Dominica Freedom Party. And Eugenia Charles in 1970, at that time, was the leader of the Freedom Party.
So the viewing continues, Cecil. Is this, I'm trying to remember his name.
Hanif Ali, the port. As a matter of fact, he worked at the port. They were very close, you know.
Mais ça, ça qui est important quand on historien l'âge pour nous, ça qui est important c'est pour savoir, mon cap pense que tu as un certain âge, peut-être 20 années ou comme ça.
Non, mon pas 20 années.
C'est pas comme ça. C'est aussi life at a very, very early age.
I was older than that. You see, the problem is, Ivona, is my mother and father, they were part of the Labour Party of Libla, and my father.
You never had political aspirations, by the way?
I never did. I found myself involved and going up in 2005 for the Dominican Labour Party. But I never felt in my life that I would have done this. And I did this because I felt that the Labour Party needed someone to represent the people. And so I made myself available. I lost by some 369 votes against Julius Timothy. But be it what it is, you know, I never really placed my mind to political aspirations.
Mais actuellement, c'est en tant que ça, là, où tu es bien jeune. Il y avait toutes ces bagages qui ont été faites. Dominique, qualité pour l'indépendance. Enfin, Dominique, en fait, capable de pour Dougout, pour Pacroy. Mais aussi un jeune Tibourg, là, c'est mon Sadibourg. Dis-nous quoi de cette sens-là, comment Dominique était, comment il était peut-être pour un jeune homme en cette sens-là.
We have turned as interviewers. So we are now interrogating Cecil.
I remember, you know, coming from the country, living in town, my mom from Vickers, living in Fields Lane, as a matter of fact, before living in Fields Lane, I had a tragedy with a fire. Thanks God, I made it. Mm-hmm. And that was on King George Street, Gate George Street, sorry. And then my mom went and lived in Fields Lane. And I remember in Rosa there was light. But we used to have this 40-watt bulb. And your mother would always remind you, do not put on this bulb before 7 o'clock at night.
Cecil, even remember the wattage, you see? 40 watts. Go on, you know? Cecil.
And we had no water. We had no pipe-borne water at the time. As that means we had no toilets. And then we had to get to the river or the sea. We would have these makeshift toilets with our white pails. And many people can talk about that my age in Roseau. And about 11, 12 o'clock, you know, at night, you know, we would go for our mom or dad to get dispose of the fetus that we would have gathered at the time, you know.
The feces
at the time that we would have gathered. And so, you know, we did what we had to do, Ivona, to really ensure that we live a life. When we get to the country, there was no light, so we had what was called buzai, you know. in the northeast of Dominica, that was Vicars, you know, Buzai. To get to Penville to was Buzai. We had to walk, you know, because there was only about two trucks. The father of the present Prime Minister, Mr. Royer, present Prime Minister's father, Alex, you know, would have a truck and Kawe, you know, at that time, you know, and they would not have ventured to get to Penville, to Upper Penville, because it was rocky roads, no lights, and so we most times during the Christmas season we had to walk. So Dominica, Roseau in particular, was a shabby city. Beautiful city, but was still shabby.
Roseau wasn't earmarked to be the capital, you know.
It's actually Portsmouth.
Right, it was Portsmouth.
Yes. But because Portsmouth had so much mosquitoes, you know, as we say, migraine in those days, so they looked at the French and the British looked at Roseau as the French more so looked at Roseau as the area where they could really have enough space, you know, large portion of land, you know, flat enough.
Don't want to interrupt you. I just saw the DFA bus, you know, making its way. So I guess they have just left.
Mais ça c'est là où parler quand c'est expérience avec comment était en Villa Roseau. Ça qu'a fait au patch sens le Patrick John Vini en pouvoir l'office pour voir cette bagarre qui monte qu'a expérience pour un petit hot system. Nous parler quand ou t'en pour aller en live là et pas ni glow. Et fait ça pour c'est mon âge là qui j'ai passé la journée. Je mentionne mon qui était qu'a western là coudé. Pour ça vous en imaginer comment yo qu'a senti pour même mon là qui était ba opportunité pour nous mais vivre.
That's why my mother and my father to this present day, you know, always looked at Patrick John. Always looked at Patrick John as a great leader. They give their allegiance right now to the Dominican Labour Party and Roosevelt Skerritt, but their allegiance has always been to the Dominican Labour Party because of the works that Patrick John was able to do, taken from that arm of Iolibla.
But as you mentioned that, Cecil, a name comes to mind as well, N.A.N. Dukri.
Yes, Nan
so
Dukri.
So you remember people like that, you know, especially, you know, at a time like this when we are saying goodbye to Patrick John, because he too was a formidable force.
Also, Nan Dukri was a big force to be reckoned with, and that's why when Patrick John had to run against Nan, it was a difficult moment for Patrick, because he felt that Nan was such a powerful individual, a businessman by that, and how possible that a person like Patrick John would have really gotten all of the votes to really make him become what he wanted to become, that is parliamentary representative. But you see, in 70, Lodah and Trafalgar was part of the constituency of the Roseau Northern. So you had Lodah, you had Trafalgar, you had Goodwill.
Cecil, let me interrupt you because someone is saying, whoa, whoa, whoa. Cecil is a living encyclopedia. I'm enjoying the history. Great guy. I think I'm going to have a special program on radio. And I want Cecil with me. Cecil, we need to talk history. Seriously. But let me say thanks to that person who said this, and someone else is saying good information, guys. You all are doing well. Well, we are trying, and with the help of Cecil, of course, we have to do what we have to do, because Cecil would have it no other way for us to just come here and talk about what is happening now. But he believes that it's important that we bring the history, and that is good. Yes. Cecil.
And we will remember in 1975, when Patrick John now was going up as the leader of now the Dominica Labour Party, with the symbol, the shoe, you know. He called his team the electrifying team of 21 candidates from 21 constituencies. And that says of Patrick John, he looked for some of the best people to run for the party.
I think earlier says we would have said Patricia Ansem.
Richards. It was Ansem. Because her
Patricia
husband
Ansem
is Richard.
Is not Richards.
Her husband is Richard Ansem.
All right.
So that's what I got. So I just want to apologize. Yes, it's Patricia Ansem. And thank
people are listening closely, and that's good.
Mais Cecil, pour autre que mentionner au sein de cet an qui a eu une professeur de changement là, il y a 11 différents secteurs politiques à présent. Nous en avons 21. Est-ce que ça de nous en fait avant de nous faire interview, nous qui interview? Est-ce que ça de nous? Est-ce ni compatriotes qui ont quitté nous? Mais est-ce que ni monde qui vivant parmi ces monde là qui était monté en ces différents secteurs?
Oh yes, we still have Iolibla. Sorry.
No,
sorry. We still have Oliver Seraphine, OJ Seraphine. Mm-hmm. We still have Mr. Parilov, Ferdinand Parilov.
Okay.
We still have Lennox Honeychurch, still alive in those days, you know.
Who knew?
Many persons would know, you know. So in 75, Patrick John had this electrifying team, and he won 16 out of 21. And that says the power of the man Patrick John, having to go around the country to convince people at the time, knowing that the Labour Party had all of its arguments and so on, to bring the Labour Party together, to have the shoe as a symbol of the Labour Party, because previously, the last election, it was the hat. And so Patrick John ran with a team, a powerful team of 21. And so you saw Patrick John won. He ran for the Kotel constituency. At that time, there was no Trafalgar and Loda. So it was called the Rose Valley. And then from that, you know, you had Mr. Michael Anthony Douglas ran for Portsmouth constituency.
It's just unfortunate that we're only mentioning Michael Douglas for the very first time on this. But Michael Douglas was a great orator of the finest pedigree. And I understood it as well. In fact, I heard of some of it when I was growing up. Patrick John, too, you know, he was not easy in Parliament. So it's interesting that you brought this up as well.
I think Mike became the great orator. I think he was always a great orator, but I think his light began to shine when Patrick John fired him in 1976 or 77, January of 1976. When Patrick John,
but the Douglases, yeah. I mean the Douglases was, you know, and they speak well, you know, that is the trait, you know, been carried through the generations.
It took when Patrick John, it took Patrick John, you know, when Patrick John fired Michael Douglas to really see the real pedigree of the man, Michael Douglas, because in those days Patrick John was nothing.
I tell
easy.
You, that's why I said at the start, to speak about Patrick John is to talk about the political landscape of Dominica, but just not only politics. There are a lot of things, of course, that we have to look at when we look at this man who is being exposed. His body has been exposed here at this.
If I say into ways, I'm not going to know what Bravo Book on men. Nous avons un programme sur mon copain Patrick John. Oui, donc il y a un programme pour United Tapis. Moi, pour United, c'est pas même assez pour parler contre trois vailles. C'est mon salaire, ben, effet qui c'est mon salaire, c'est ni à sous nous en Dominique, en société. Mais enfin, il y a bon pour ni programme. Enfin, quand on dit que les mêmes assassins sont programmes pour parler contre histoire nous. Mais il est important pour nous ça documenter ces bagages là pour enfin pour nous, mon salaire accès. Puis sur cette lettre, nous partons que les bagages là perdent toutes ces qualités histoire là. Tout ce qui est là, c'est l'information. Puis, moi, si je l'ai écouté, je l'ai admiré, vous savez, tout aspect de l'histoire, ça là, vous parlez quoi. Donc, juste vivre, vous parlez quoi, toi, là, qui Patrick John Tesney, et puis les autres, moun en région, tout ça, pas seulement Dominique, mais moun en région. Et bien, pour ça,
Milton Cato, John Compton, et Bob's Bowman.
When we talk earlier on in terms of the boundaries, you know, the actual boundaries, they had. In 1972, 1st of September 1972, constituency boundary commission was appointed. On the 8th day of June 1973, the commission submitted to His Excellency the Governor. At the time, the Governor was Sir Lukos Zlatig, a report in which it recommended that that Dominica should be divided into 21 constituencies.
Okay, so as we speak, of course, the people are still coming to view the body. Just I'm trying to make up this guy. He looks very familiar.
He's a footballer himself. He normally does.
Yes, in fact, we are related.
He's from Newtown, I think.
No. He lives in Forkoli.
In Forkoli?
Yes, he lives in Forkoli.
But I've always seen him in Newtown.
Okay, yes. He has a very close friend in Newtown, this guy. But he's from Forkoli. I think his sister passed not too long ago.
Okay.
And Whitney Houston continues to sing. It's a very somber atmosphere here. But, of course, it's really, you know, the celebration of the life of a man who had done so much.
And as I was saying earlier on of the history of the Labour Party leadership in 1974, you know, Edward Liebler vacated his seat and was filled in by Patrick John. And as we all know that, we have been talking about that for quite a lot. And on the 26th of July, Patrick John, well, became the premier of Dominica. And he took the Dominican Labour Party to victory with the shoe, and we know that Patrick John himself has done quite a lot, as you have been saying.
Yes, so
and also to Ivona, I should mention that I suspect, you know, at that time Ronald Armour was the deputy premier I try to always ask Patrick that question, and I never really got an answer from him, that Ronald Armour was the deputy premier. Mm. How did he get around to be the choice of the people of the various district, the different delegates, to be the leader of the Labour Party? I never really got that answer from him.
Oh, okay, and that would have been interesting as well if you had gotten that answer, because you know it would shape what I'm thinking of right now in terms of Ronald Armour, you know, and his position as deputy premier, you know, at that time. But of course, Cecil, I know you'll always do some further history. You may not get it, or well, you'll never get it again from Patrick John. But I mean, if you document this,
when after Ronald Armour lost, you know, he decided himself and his brother Jenner Armour, along with a few supporters of Jenner and Ronald, to form the Progressive Labour Party. Okay. So here goes another third party. Of Labour.
Yes.
So it was called the Progressive Labour Party.
As you're saying that, just stick a pin there, because I know you have a lot of history to share with us. I'm also thinking that Patrick John was once the General Secretary of the Dominican Labour Party, right?
He was the General Secretary.
And, I'm thinking as
on
well.
On two occasions.
On two occasions. And, you know, and very soon we will also afford a funeral like this for Edward Regis, who was the General Secretary of the Dominican Labour Party.
So now we're seeing the brother of Jesse John, David Kentish, former teacher.
David Kentish, also the brother
of Thomas Kentish. Brother.
My
yes.
Friend.
Yes. So, right. So this is the.
So
the
I think Desiree is being wheeled away. I think it's time. So she's leaving now. Spent a lot of time here.
And see the irony of these things in terms of the Labour parties. Jenner Armour was made the leader of the Progressive Party, and guess what? He chose the hat. The hat that the Dominican Labour Party or the Liberal Labour Party once had. He chose the hat for his party symbol.
Okay.
Can you imagine? So here goes the Liberal Labour Party in 1970 with the hat, the Dominican Labour Party with the shoe. Patrick John came in 1975, chose the shoe, and then you had the Progressive Labour Party choosing the hat.
Yes, so we have talked a lot about politics and about and sports as well, his involvement. How much do you know about his involvement in his church as well? Because he was a stout Anglican.
I always try to wonder, because Patrick John has been saying about wanting to be a brother. And I try to wonder, at what time did he become an Anglican? I never got that, you know. I'm not so sure if he was a Catholic or you know. You know, but I know that he was never a brother. I know that he wanted to be a brother, because he is very
close. And he too was very close to Brother Jermaine.
And his brother close to Brother Jermaine, yes. You know? And so I don't know at what time did he actually left the Catholic Church, if he was ever Catholic. You know? I've just told that when he got married to Desiree, that's when he went across to the Anglican Church.
Right. So, Desiree, Amelia, you are learning a lot about
it. Yes, I'm learning the power of love, too.
Was very close to Patrick John. Yes. Simeon Joseph as well was very close to Patrick John. I'm not sure if it's through the family of the Joseph family of Simeon Joseph, but Simeon Joseph too was very close to Patrick John. And Simeon Joseph's family, you know, very well known, you know, for your singing talent. So it's obvious. And you're very good at remembering as well.
Yes,
so if I know you well,
it will stay with you.
So Cecil, can you make out who is at the casket viewing now?
No one is here. Right. I think the member of the Linus Funeral Home is actually Mr. Coppell.
So this is and going to be
taking a few pictures.
A section.
It must be said to Ivona that DBS Radio is carrying this live on our Facebook and our YouTube.
Yes, we have.
So persons who actually would like to know, to take note.
Here comes this
Henry. Yeah.
From the DAP, the Association of Persons with Disabilities, and he represented Dominica in some event,
Special Olympics.
And I know
his
mother, mom,
Patrick John, we understood, okay.
About, and that's why, you know, they were very close, you know. The mother of Wicks, too, they were very close. Wicks from Gotha Village, she was also from The blind organization.
Okay. Okay.
They were very close with Patrick.
Okay, I tell you, know. When you go back to history, you'll realize that a lot of the women in particular.
Oh, yes.
In those
the women in Funkoli, Pottersville, Gotha Village. You
PJ
know,
all the way.
They were lovers of Patrick John. I mean, Patrick John could have done nothing wrong for them.
I'm trying to remember, Cecil, one of the calypsos, you know, that would have touched on Patrick John, one of the most popular ones. Can you remember?
Well, I know Patrick John wrote a song on himself, Dear John, and give it to Spider to sing.
Oh, he wrote that song.
He wrote that song, Dear John. You know, could you imagine that he wrote that song about himself? But I suspect when listening to that song lyrically is that he was actually talking about people inside of his own cabinet. You know, talking about Dear John and there's corruption, you know, and he was just actually talking about a number of other things around his party.
Here comes that song again from Gramps Morgan. Very strong number, I tell you. It says so much and it's well fitting, you know, for an occasion like this. There's a place up there for someone like you.
Yes, ça fait un moment qui vient twist là, nous avons enfin et puis famille qui était là pour venir voir cadavre John avec you pour opportunité pour quitter. Mais vous n'avez pas c'est que enfin moi comme ça c'est chaque mais pourquoi vous pouvez moi rechecter ça là encore. Mais il était bien important pour connaître la transition puis Cécile tenir opportunité ou c'est vous n'avez peut-être taken opportunité pour voir Dominique comment nous regarder anglais before and after quand enfin nous parler de Patrick Genevieve qui jouait pour taper Dominique indépendant. Pour ça, c'est encore où tu es un jeune monde, mais before and after, avant nous venir indépendant, pour après nous venir indépendant, pour nous, maintenant nous vivons un moment ça.
You're ready for a long history, right?
Yes.
Because I know a lot has changed.
The truth before independence, a number of people sometimes, when thinking about it, they wonder why did Patrick John have that vision to let Dominica become politically independent. And because we didn't have the best economies, we didn't have the best infrastructure. But Patrick felt, you know, if we can take charge of our own business, knowing that Libla on the 1st of March 1967 had already started the process of being an associated statehood by taking charge of its economy. And the British would only look at our affairs of defense. And so Patrick himself felt, even before Grenada became independent in 1974, that Libla himself wanted to have Dominica politically independent in that period. But not much was spoken about it. But then after Patrick John, in that declaration in 1976, felt that Dominica had to become an independent country. There were some fights, some circles felt that we should go for a referendum because there were three aspects that you could actually get or try to achieve political independence. One would be referendum, two, the British would just give it to you, and the other one you'd have to fight. And so the British gave it to us. I remembered as a young boy that when the opposition themselves went to England with Patrick, some of the Labour Party old stalwarts made noise with Patrick, Puku Kamene Eugenia Charles Allon. But he saw the importance of bringing Eugenia Charles. So it was Eugenia Charles, Lennox Honeychurch, and Papa Moise, Anthony Moise from Soufriere. At the time, Lennox, I think, was a third nominee. Those days we were not saying senator, but he's the first nominee in Parliament. And so Patrick went with Mr. former Premier, Mr. Libla, himself. Vic Riviere, that of Michael Douglas, and there was a fifth person I'm trying to remember, but there were actually five of them who went. Oh, and Mr. Shaw, Vernon Shaw, who was cabinet secretary and later on became president of the Commonwealth of Dominica. And they went to England, and the British eventually decided that they were going to give Dominica political independence. And when that was happening, I think Eugenia Charles made the quest, why can't we not have a president again to try to delay? And so I think Patrick John took a boogie and decided that he was going to agree to having a president. And so that's why from today on, we still do have a president. And Dominica, as I said earlier on, was the second country of the Caribbean, Guyana the first, to have a president.
But if you allow me, Cecil, I'm sorry, Ivona, let me just take this opportunity to ask you the question in English. I mean, at that time, very young, you mentioned that some folks were not for that decision. Of course, we're not being economically stable, we were not at that level on our own, at least. But as a young man, was there a sense of confusion? I mean, some were for, some were against, but
What were your thoughts then?
No, I remember I was just about 15 years old, and with my political aspirations within the armpits of the Labour Youth Organization, thank God a guy like Rosie Douglas came on board. Rosie came from Canada. I don't want to use the word rebel, but had a different view. And so requested of Patrick John to go around the country to really help and to make people have a better understanding as to what political independence means to us. And with the help, you find that the Rozo people, the elite of the Rozo, of the Rozo clan,
the bourgeoisies,
would be the ones crying for referendum. And as we're saying this, we're saying Vincent Aitken from Portsmouth is just passing to ensure that he too worked at Dexia once upon a time and showing his final respect. And then you find that when Patrick John went around the country, together with that of Rosie Douglas and the Popular Independent Committee, that people by and large wanted to have independence. Not like a day like today where you have the social media, but people by and large, I mean, Patrick John had just won the election, had 16 seats. You would have expected that people would have agreed with Patrick John and wanting to have independence. So when that happened, they saw, and I think Eugenia Charles and the Freedom Party, they will give a different answer, but I'm sure that they too went around the country to try to maybe change the minds of these people from the rural areas. But the people from the rural areas were very strong with that of Patrick John and the then, at the time, Dominican Labour Party.
But it's amazing, though, when we are in a history session. It's amazing when you hear, you know, folks in the opposition and you know, the folks in power at the time are coming together for one cause. It's amazing to see how, you know, how people can unite for the same cause.
I honestly believe, though, what the Freedom Party did not want, and I'm not subject to change here, that is my belief, that the Freedom Party wanted to be the people to bring Dominica into political independence and not to have the name of Patrick John as the first Prime Minister of Dominica. I don't think, by and large, the Freedom Party was against politics. When you hear the excuses that they gave was, one, Patrick John was a social democrat, two, Patrick John would make us communists, three, Patrick John would take out the church from us, and four, Patrick John wasn't the right man at the time because. And I'm saying that we then saw, because I think Patrick John's vision was to get independence in 1977, but we eventually got it a year later. And see what happened. Six months later, that there was no more Patrick John as Prime Minister of Dominica. So the intention for me was very clear, that it was not the fact of wanting to not have political independence. For me, it was about who would be the first Prime Minister.
When you look at what is happening now on the political landscape, a lot has changed, a lot remains the same. But Cecil, even as you mentioned, you know, Patrick John, of course, has been premier, and that's something that we can never forget. We have to remember some of the former presidents as well. So I remember Louis Coles Latigue, you know, and people like Aurelius Marie, I think. Cecil, we also had Fred Degazon, right? If memory serves me right.
You forget Mr. Amo, Jenna Amo.
Jenna Amo as well, yes. You know. So these people really shaped, you know, the political landscape of the nation.
It should be said that, because quite a number of people are of the view that Patrick John lost power on the 29th of May. That is not a fact. Patrick John, actually, on the 21st of July, 1979, of June, sorry, 1979, that 12 members of his cabinet went to the president at the time, General.
That
Amo.
Was really a tumultuous period in our history.
And they went to the president and decided that they would call a vote of no confidence on Patrick John. And so that gave the power to the man Oliver Seraphim to be the Prime Minister of Dominica. We heard people say that he was the interim Prime Minister. But bit what it is, you know. But the fact is that when these 12 members of parliament actually went to the president, that's when Patrick John lost power.
Yeah, so there's something I'm just learning as well, very interesting. The parliament representative for the Salisbury constituency was...
Salibia,
let's get this right.
Yes.
He came with his hands tied. They brought him in fact with his hands tied.
They brought him.
What happened? Tell us. Wow.
Actually, he refused to resign.
I thought we had preventive issues now when we were back
He refused to resign. And because he refused to resign, that a few people who wanted Oliver, you know, because of Oliver Leblanc, because remember, you had to get a two-thirds majority. And here it is, if you have 11, the president won't agree with you. So they had to have 12. So they got him to sign by using force, if I could say, you know. And that is something that the history doesn't tell us. But that is the fact. That is the fact.
I like what is being played right now. You know, this song done by Morgan Heritage and Buju Banton, you know, the 23rd Psalm.
Yes.
Fine selections here we have heard this morning. And the viewing continues as the public is afforded that opportunity to view the body of former Prime Minister, former Premier Patrick John, Patrick Roland John. And I'm not sure who is at the area. No one yet.
Okay, no one yet. And we were talking about earlier on about 1975, you know, some of the seats that the Dominican Labour Party won under Patrick John as Premier. He won the Newtown constituency, the Goodwill constituency, Canefield constituency. The Newtown constituency was, I think, Mr. Eustace Francis. He was an attorney. Goodwill was the man Patrick John. Canefield was O.G. Seraphine.
Okay.
Maho was Vic Riviere. St. Joseph, I think, was Lando. He was a police officer, former police officer. Salisbury was Mr. Louis. Collio, trying to remember who was. Ferdinand Parillo. Then Portsmouth, Mike Douglas. Cottage was Mr. Dubois. Vickers was Eden Bowers. Sally Beer was Daru. Pebush was at the time Mr. Bannis. Wesley was Mr. Theodore. Petit Savan, trying to remember who was Petit Savan. Wow. And Laplane was Mr. Christian. Catibus was Romanus Bannis.
Cecil Joseph, when the Lord asks you, what did you do with the talent that I gave to you? I hope you you will be pleased and say, yes, there's one I remember to do. To serve as an historian.
Pretty Savan was Luke Corriott.
Yes.
He passed on, I think, about 2 years ago, you know. I remember talking to Luke Corriott, you know.
I think Luke Corriott would have died somewhere around October, you know.
Yes, October, November. I remember when Luke died, you know, before he died, we were discussing a number of issues with that of Patrick, with Mr. President Prime Minister. They were very close himself, you know, and discussing a number of issues in reference to the Petit Savan constituency. And so this was the 16 persons who won the election in 1975. They were called the electrifying team. And in that electrifying team, you know, Premier John was able to bring us the National Bank of Dominica. I've given DBS Radio some pictures of that inauguration of the National Bank, March of 1978. And it's a moment for Dominica at the time, because at the time there was just the Royal Bank, the Barclays Bank, and the National Bank. And you had the Penny Bank, that was the bank of Eugenio Charles' father. How could I forget that man's name? He's a big man in Dominica, Eugenio Charles' father. J.B. Charles, you know. The Penny Bank, and then the eight bank started in 1971 under Leblanc. At the time, it was on the top floor of the ministerial building.
In fact, we are celebrating 50 years this year together with the eight bank.
And then, when the National Bank was built, the eight bank was on the second floor of the National Bank. So these two buildings were actually twinned together for a number of years until now the 8th Bank has its own space.
Cecil, as you mentioned the 8th Bank, I remember in the discussion with you yesterday, you noted that Patrick John got a significant sum of money from the Caribbean Development Bank to start a housing project in
Dominica. Yes, I remember that very clearly, like yesterday. I remember Patrick John coming to my mother and father.
Just make mention of Mickey Morrow.
He too was a councillor of the Rosa City Council.
Was his father and Patrick John?
His father is a Frenchman, but his father, when he came to Dominica, actually worked quite a lot in Portersville with Patrick John.
Okay.
And so Mickey Morrow's father was always a staunch Labourite, Mr. Morrow.
Okay, so I was asking about the CDB.
Yes, I was saying to you that I remember Patrick John coming home to my mother and father, and if they're listening, they will applaud me for remembering that, and say to my mom that they need to set up something to convince the CDB that he needed a sum of money to build some houses in Bath Estate. And so, for the very first time, I saw a big camera on Fields Lane of my mother with a big basin of clothes, which she normally used to do every week. And with myself and my brother Reginald holding the skirt of my mom, and my mom has a basin on her head and a pail.
Remember the color of the basin?
The color of the basin was white. On those days, everything was white. Nothing, everything was white, you know. And showing us walking onto Fields Lane, you know, to help to convince the bank that yes, these are for the people. Maybe they have done it with other people around Dominica, in Portersville. In those days, it was Portersville, Funcoli, New Tong, and some part of Roseau that Patrick John was actually looking out for those houses. When those houses were being built, I remembered a number of people would come to Bath Estate to criticize the houses by saying, these are houses made for pigs, you wouldn't put the best dogs in it. And, but, you know, it was
somewhere
a vision.
Somewhere in wood, right?
So some decided the wooden houses first.
Okay.
And then they went to the block. So some 210 houses will be built. And so those houses are today standing after 40 years. Oh, right.
Hurricane David
passed, you know. The number of houses who stood Hurricane David in 1979 and still withstand Hurricane Maria. And so yes. It's important. This coffee, young coffee, that's where Patrick John actually raised the house. Where Patrick was born, was where this guy presently lives.
The brother of Franklin Coffey. Okay.
Just came and have his last, pay his last respect to Patrick. So I know that when the houses were being built in Bath Estate, it wasn't just a thank you. Now we're seeing Carlton Winston, of the First Serenade Band, coming to show his last respects.
Just recently, Patrick. The First Serenade Band bid farewell to Archie Adrian
the
Winston. Bassman. Yes, Adrian Winston. So he's coming to pay his last respect. But Cecil, I'm really enjoying this because, as I said, to talk about Patrick John is to talk about so much, not just about the political landscape in Dominica. You talk
and
about
even remembering the Provident Fund. I don't know if you remember that name.
So Provident that came Fund. before the social security.
Yeah. So you had the Provident Fund. Where you see now the Jolly Pharmacy is, the Jolly Pharmacy, not your Greens used to be, but the Jolly Pharmacy where they presently have the business. Mm-hmm. Upstairs was the Providence Fund. And then Patrick John felt that he wanted to ensure that he helped the ordinary man and woman of Dominica. And so he established the Dominica Social Security. And years later, St. Lucia came on board and established the NIS, I think, the National Insurance Scheme, And
and around that time as well, Cecil, you know, Dominicans knew how to save. They would save every penny. Of course, they helped tremendously, you know, in setting up the credit union. So Code Maisel, you know, was big in Dominica.
Yes.
Saving, putting money together, having little subs, you know, that was the culture back then, you know, Cecil. As I said earlier, a lot has changed, but a lot remains the same.
Some people have forgotten that Patrick John was also Minister of Agriculture. And I remember the very first time some of us as young boys would have heard the word Lisport.
Leaf spot disease.
You know, and some farmers try to make a storm about the leaf spot disease. And at the time, you know, bananas has been exported to Britain.
And at that time, bananas was king.
And at that time, banana was king. You know, and so Patrick himself played an important role in creating or establishing the feeder roads. Mm-hmm. So quite a number of communities in Dominica with feeder roads would be that of the hands of Patrick John.
So yes, we have to talk about these things. I mean, when you look at where the banana industry is now, I mean, years gone by, bananas was it, you know, we were standing strong on bananas. Mm-hmm. And there came a time whenever we were kicking at goal, the goal post was being shifted. There were so many trade regulations and so many other things that we had to grapple with, you know. A lot of diseases came on board and really, you know, helped in sort of bringing down this once important industry. But we continue to fight. It shows our resilience, you know, as a people, you know, how much we have had to grapple with as a small island developing state. But there's always a milieu, you know, that desire to move on. And whilst it's unfortunate that most times we only come together in the face of adversity, it still says that, you know, we are somewhat still united as a people.
But we have ça l'avait le web le on peut cacher les codes ça là vous mettez ça commencer à au savoir l'idée pour mes mains pour nous de ça sortir hot l'anglais pour apprendre au monde qui dit 42 years that's it
Vous comprenez là où les putains tout ça Dominique j'ai espéré en CFR ça même M. Joseph qui a parlé contre ces challenges là qui étaient là en ce temps là avec l'homme vous regardez là nous et même là nous si c'est tout à présent à stadium là à la course stadium là avec quand il était avant ok ni pour ça moi de 40 années c'est tout is that all
yeah. It should also be said to Million Ivona that so many things you know that you don't have all of the knowledge. And so Patrick John would have depended on a number of people to help him in framing Dominica. And so he would have gotten some ill advice from one or two of his own supporters, or even maybe within cabinet. And so let's not forget that, you know, that some people themselves within the administration or support of Patrick John, maybe ill advised would have considered it, maybe not having enough capacity to understand what would have happened tomorrow. So yes, if someone is to ask me if he got some ill advice, I would say yes.
What would that be?
What would that be? I think in reference to May 29th, the persons who said to him continue, gave him an ill advice. Rather they should have said to him, you know, chief, I think today we could suspend Parliament to calm the people down and to meet the people. And I'm sure that some persons ill advise him to say, go to Parliament and pass your bill. And then we saw what the results was, you know?
Okay, so it's kind of quiet now in terms of the number of people, you know, coming to view right now. But as I said, it's well organized, special section cordoned off for that very purpose. And people are making their way. There's a special entrance and there's an exit as well. And that is flowing smoothly as, of course, we pay last respects to former Prime Minister Patrick John, who will be laid to rest tomorrow. And we will be bringing live as well, Cecil, that broadcast. And will we be here tomorrow again? Yes, I think so. I think it's important that we do this. Well, not here, yes. But it's important that we do this, as I said. It is part of our agenda, you know, as the national broadcaster. And yes, we will do it. And if we are here still, we will do it for Edward Regis as well. And we'll do it for many other people. We had a very, very good program this morning. The reviews are positive, and that's what I like, you know. I like the fact that even if we have young people right now, you know, at DBS Radio, they can continue to follow that foundation, you know, in terms of production material, you know, and things like that. And as I speak, I see this man on his with a cane walking. He can hardly move.
Conrad?
He moves. I'm not seeing him properly. Does he move with a cane? I haven't.
Cornbread, unless he had it recently.
The mass is so much on.
I don't know.
Maybe it's cornbread. It must be cornbread.
Okay, all right. So he's moving it for cane.
Cornbread. Yes, it will be cornbread.
And he has made the sign of the cross. Cecil.
Yes.
He considered
me as his cousin, you know.
He came from that area.
Yes.
Yeah, it was a beth time. Beth
time.
You know, every day. Lagoon, you know those areas.
Lava boy, you know.
Yes, you know. I spoke to, I can remember when we were doing a production not too long ago, and I spoke to Reginald Monjuri. I think what died at that time? I'm not even too sure. Was it Mr. Dukri? When Mr. Dukri died. And, you know, I got so much history from, you know, from Monjuri. So people like Cornbread as well, you know, they have a lot of history.
For sure, Monjuri, you know, Richard Frederick Monjuri. Would have had quite a lot of
Frederick.
Information,
okay.
Because he too was part and parcel of the Labour Party. I'm seeing a young lady, her name is Claudia Tewitt. I know her very well. Her father was very much involved with Patrick John. Her father got a house in Bath Estate and played a big role with Patrick John. That is also
who
the daughter of Miss Harris, granddaughter of Miss Harris.
Okay.
Miss Rumor, the daughter of Rumor Harris, but the granddaughter of Mrs. Harris.
Now, who
was a staunch Labourite.
Yes, another one, Cecil. Please don't forget.
She's a younger lady, I'm not so sure.
You're not too sure.
Can't make out that one.
All right.
You know? Yes.
Probably too young. I tell you, Cecil can tell you, take you back to the yards. Did you go to my yard? Did you visit my yard in Independence Street?
We are very often.
The churches now?
Very often.
Your Pastor Rodney.
Very often.
Okay.
This young lady, Frederica, she's from Bath Estate. Her mom was very, very, we call them at the time Caribs.
Okay.
No, the Kalinago. Patrick John used to visit their home practically every week, you know.
Oh, yes, I know her well, yes.
And so it would have been a big loss. Mm-hmm. For
he
the family,
as a father figure as well.
He was a father figure
in the
family.
Yes.
You know, the one of the daughters actually lived with. I'm not lived, but worked with Patrick John at the Football Association.
Who is this lady, Cecil? Do you make
I'm
her?
I'm trying to make out who she
no,
is. No,
you don't.
I,
okay.
No,
so
I don't.
Move on because there's a little line.
And
now,
the next
people
person I'm
coming.
Seeing coming in is a guy who raised with his mom Miss Chokad, Darius Liquent is his name. And Darius Liquent actually helped his mother to write and to do editing of the Labour Party's paper in those days.
Okay.
Darius Liquent now is a constitutional lawyer. That looks like Mr. He's a footballer, Clarendon.
Okay.
It looks like Mr. Clarendon quite a bit. No, it's not Mr. Clarendon, is it? With this Macedonian thing. No. This is a young guy from Portersville. Okay. Played for the Swansea Domino Club. I'm trying to remember his name.
Oh, yes. Yeah. Ted Daly's good friend.
Yes, Ted Daly's good friend.
Yeah, now, and so as I said, like, let me just say hello to Ted Daly and to Ophelia as well. Ted Daly, of course, residing in St. Croix. You know, we talk now and then. I always keep in contact with Ted Daly. Of course, Patrick John is his father-in-law.
Yes.
Or was his father-in-law, of course. Yes. So let me say good day to Ted Daly. A lot of sun here right now, you know, but it's really a beautiful ambience. I mean, the people who ensured that this setting looks like it is looking now.
And we need to compliment the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the government of Dominica for the kind of setting. You know, it's really a pretty ambience. It's really one well thought of, you know. Mm-hmm. And the way it is done, the solemnity that
not actually too much, you know, it's like much. Less is more.
Yes,
and it's really, you know, it's really a suiting.
And I'm sure the occasion. That Patrick John family would be proud, you know, as to seeing, you know, the kind of effort that has been made in ensuring that the final pieces of this official viewing is done properly.
All right, so it's after 12. Of course, we have news at 1:15. We go up until about 1 o'clock. DBS Radio, of course, bringing this live both on YouTube and on Facebook and on the radio, all our frequencies. You can hear us, you know, bringing this to you. This is part of our history. And
we remember also to Ivona and Amelia that in 1980, you know, Patrick John again ran for the Rosa North constituency. This is the first time that this constituency has changed name. So you have Rosa Northern in 1970, Goodwill in 1975, and in 1980 it was called the Rosa North constituency. To this present,
Rosa Northern, then
and then Goodwill,
and then Rosa North,
and then Rosa North. And Patrick John ran in that constituency again, and lost against Mr. Dyer. I think it's Babs Dyer. Patrick John got 1,279 votes, getting something like 49.69%, or we can say 45% of the votes, and Babs Dyer of the Freedom Party got some 58.4% of the votes, you know. And Eustace Francis himself ran and got just about 6.37% of
hats off to Cecil. I tell you, I have about 8 exercise books myself, and I write a lot. Let me tell you, I write a lot, and I thought that it was strange that I'm
here today. I mean, it speaks volume of who we are as a national station.
So we are getting some thoracic lubrication at this time. We have been talking a lot, so we welcome this from the technician on duty, Dean Thomas. So thank you, Dean. And so we continue to bring this.
And we would know that in 1980, as I said, that Patrick John lost the election in the Rosa North constituency. But in 1985, he continued the mission and ran in St. Joseph. And won, and he won over Caleb Laura from St. Joseph himself. At that time, we would all know that the Dominican Labour Party was a very popular party on the western coast of Dominica, Maho, Collioure, St. Joseph, you know, Canefield. So the Labour Party in 1985, Patrick John chose to run for the Dominican Labour Party in the St. Joseph constituency and won over a man. Today his name is on, as we are sitting here, we can see his name alongside the stand of Clem John and Caleb Laura.
Okay, all right.
Stand number 303 to 301.
So Caleb, school is named after him.
A school is named after him. So that tells you of the man. He played for the Windward Island. And Patrick John was able to play cricket for Dominican for the Windward Island. And Patrick John was able to go along to St. Joseph and won Caleb Laura by some 74 votes. Caleb Laura getting 899 votes, and which was like 48% of the votes. And Patrick John getting 51.51% of the votes, 52% of the votes, getting 973.
Yes, sir. I wonder what is in place, though. Let's going forward in terms of, you know, the memory of Patrick John. Is there an edifice or museum, you know, I would like to see, you know, something, you know, people remember Patrick John. And there's a lot, of course, you can remember him by. I mean, just go to Bathurst and go to some of the other places. But I would like to see probably a monument, you know.
And we'll remember that in 19, 85, that same year that he won the election, mm-hmm. that he was jailed, he was placed in prison for 12 years.
I have not even looked at that.
Yes,
I just looked. To speak about Patrick Jones, yes. is to speak about that as well. Yes, you know, you cannot leave this out. This is very important as well.
And he went to jail in that period. And as I said, it was planned for
but
him.
But just even as you mentioned that, I just want to ask: is this done at regular intervals? At times, I see the policemen. They change shifts. Okay, all right.
Yeah,
okay.
That is done at regular intervals. Yes, okay. It is done. So as we were saying that Patrick John went to jail, and it was supposed to be for 12 years.
Well, that was crying time for a lot of people in Dominica,
including my parents, myself.
Oh my goodness!
You know, it was really hurting times. So, but you know what? We still visit him in the jail because we felt almost committed to him. And so, there are times, you know, even when you had to pay for lawyers that the supporters of the Labour Party would come go around the country. And to raise money to.
And as
to
you mentioned, that I remember even in those days, people like Flossie Joseph, you know, mm-hmm. I think they too would have helped in that, you know, gathering, you know, finance, you know, to help, you know, with legal fees and all of that. So yes, we have to bring in those people as well when we speak about Patrick John and when we speak about politics in Dominica. So people are continuing to come in. There's another lady now who is viewing. Can you, is this Ayola? Ayola George?
Ayola John.
Okay, Ayola George of Dexia. Yeah.
Yes. Her mother herself would have been Jacinta Kaji.
Banis.
Yes, Jacinta Banis would have been one who worked with Patrick John.
Okay.
So she's here, I'm sure, representing her mom. Okay. You know, and herself, you know. And you can see that she took.
I love this song that's on right now. There's something about me and music on my head. There's something about me and music. I just have this ear for music. I love a good song. The God of the Mountain is still God in the Valley.
Mais oui, bien sûr. Sa exposition à ça c'est à cadavre à la coupe qui va public là. Opportunité pour ouais et cadavre là dans le sens où ça même dit pour les aider à plein monde qui a été là, ben peut-être monde qui Patrick John même touché la vie, ou qui une opportunité à pour venir ouais une dernière fois avant qu'il y ait quelque chose demain. Gouvernement Dominique qui a offert parce que demain après-midi, l'organisation a venu d'aider nos associations quand ils vont continuer à dire, là on parle de Patrick John, c'est pas seulement politique, hein, c'est un monde qui est dénié sur tout aspect société.
I have not seen the Harry Spint people coming in here yet. Patrick John was very much instrumental in 1978. Remember in those days, Harry Spint was actually coming from Barbados, and Patrick John was very instrumental to get Harry Spint in Dominica. Its first building was in Foncole. Getting up to where Maxwell Trading Area is, you know, and Patrick Jones. Ninian Marie was then the general manager of Harry Spint, you know, and so I would have, I'm sure that maybe sometime along during the day, that would see people from the Harry Spint, you know, showing their last respect to Patrick Jones, because if it wasn't for his negotiation, I don't think Harry Spint would have been here today.
So this goes on for how long? For until what time?
Until 2 o'clock.
Until 2 o'clock this afternoon. Okay. So I can imagine at 1 o'clock, you know, many people, you know, on their lunch break, you know, they would take the opportunity to come as well.
Yes.
And to pay their last respect.
As I was saying earlier on though too about Patrick John taking jail, you know, as Fit would have put it, you know, he did not take the 12 years. And just imagine the date that he was released. He was released on the 29th of May. And we remember the importance of 29th of May in Dominica's history. And he was released in 1990 on the 29th of May, again from the hands of the Dominica Freedom Party. And sometimes I tend to think deep as to the rationale for taking jail and the rationale to remove him from jail before the 12 years. You know, so that is within your own mind. You can think as to how far or wide you'd wish. But I have my own thinkings. But in 1995, he again returned to the political landscape. He decided that he was going to run again for the Dominica Labour Party, the shoe party, that he belongs to, and he ran in 1995.
It just tells about who he really was, you know, like a rebel leader, not rebel in a bad sense. Yes. Because as you said that, I just remember Jack Warner as well, you know, and Jack would have done the same thing. Mm-hmm. And of course, they were very close friends as well, Patrick John and Jack Warner, the former FIFA vice president. So we see a few people coming in again.
And this is the Fokoli Health Team.
Okay, Fokoli Health
Team. We know that the Fokoli Health Team themselves played a role in really helping Patrick while he was ill, you know.
Okay,
so that tells you his real focus on the people. And so the people themselves, when he was ill, actually went back and really helped him. And just imagine the Fokoli Health Team, mm-hmm. you know.
And they are younger people, you know.
And they're younger people. The parents would have been the ones who would have been standing there for Patrick John and with Patrick John. And so, you know, it is good that they could recognize his efforts as a leader in Dominica and could come and pay their last respects.
Yes, and as we speak, so they're making their way now to get the final viewing of PJ, the man, Papa Adep on us. And a few of them are here, the Fokoli Health Team. First responders, very busy, particularly around that time. But it's really good that they got some time to come and do this, because this for them is important. This for them says a lot. So they are paid the last respect as we speak. The Fokoli Health Team, but let me just say bravo to them. You know, we have to recognize these people who continue to do so much, who are at the forefront where it concerns health and this time that we are facing with COVID-19.
Yes, Ivona, and we are here at the Windsor Park Sports Stadium Hard Courts, giving our last respects to a leader, a man who stood for Dominica, who brought Dominica political independence. We saw earlier on his wife was here, she has left, paying her last respects. I'm sure tomorrow again she will be at the church service at the cathedral. The cathedral chapel tomorrow, I think at 2:00, and we will be live also bringing to you the many listeners of DBS Radio, both live on audio and that of a video. And I just want to tell our many listeners that you can go onto our website, to our Facebook and our YouTube page, and you can see live. We are the only ones here bringing this live to the general public, and
it's also been carried live on GIS, isn't it?
I think they might be doing the recording of it. Okay. Here today, we have it sent out later. But
is
we are
this
here.
I'm trying to make out this gentleman. Is he
Dangleben?
Okay, Dangleben. Oh, that's my good friend, Christopher Dangleben.
Yes,
I tell you, there's something with the masks, you know. Calypso Association. He would have worked with Fiji as well.
And he would have worked with Patrick John. Oh, as we talk about the Calypso Association, Patrick John himself wrote a number of songs.
Yes,
as I said earlier on, he wrote for Spider, singing a song, Dear John, and to listen to that song lyrically, it was wicked. He also wrote for Peaky. He wrote Beauty Begins with a D, talking about Dominica, and he also wrote for Peaky that song Black. Black, you know, talking about everything that we as the black people have done. A powerful song.
Yeah, these are powerful
written
songs.
by Patrick.
When you look at the lyrics, you know, lyrical content.
And also he wrote for The Observer and a few other Calypsonians. The Hunter, for sure, the one of The Hunter is one that many people are aware of, but Patrick John wrote quite a number of Calypsons.
I think he wrote Cry of the Paro.
I'm not so sure if he wrote Cry of the Paro. I'm trying to remember who actually maybe could, but I'm
but
not
Patrick
so sure.
John penned
but penned quite a lot of calypsos.
Oh yes.
And he
was an MC as well, you know. Around that time we had Urban Harrigan and Patrick John, you know.
I mean, it was amazing, you know, Patrick John putting a woman's clothes on him, Urban Harrigan himself doing the same. I mean, interchanging. I mean, this is Naomi's mother.
Rufan,
Naomi's mother. She was at the time together with the son of Patrick John, mm-hmm. that's Renick. Mm-hmm. So she would have come here today and pay her last respect to Patrick John. I have not seen Irma Ostry. I have not seen Fiorina Woodman Porn.
At some point, yes. Well, I'm some told people that, are overseas as well. Yes?
You know, but I'm sure that these two people, they're not here. They would have liked to be here, but I'm sure that they might be viewing via our network. And I'm happy that Ivona, that we are able to bring it to a number of people who would not have been here. I'm sure that my mom and my dad in Connecticut, in the United States of America, are actually looking on.
You see what happens when radio meets social media.
Yes, I'm sure Snapper,
the son of Cyrene,
you know, would be looking, you know. Early on, he told me that he was actually crying, you know, literally crying, knowing what Patrick John has done for his mom.
And he would remember a lot Sasai, you know, and Patrick John, they were close back in the day. Let me say good afternoon to Cyrene Eugene Sasai in Baffin State and the family as well. So who is making the entrance here, Amelia? Oh, no. Okay, so that is one of the workers, okay, of the funeral home.
So another guy coming in
so
here.
Jimmy Clayton singing Many Rivers, of course.
This is a shirt of 1975, Vought PJ. Oh, my God. I need a picture of this one.
Yes.
My God. That's the year that PJ lost in 1980. In 1980. With the symbol, the shoe. Oh, my God.
Can you imagine how much it survived? So, Cecily, I think you should take a photo of it when he's making his exit.
Yes.
And I probably think, too, though, he might be the only person that I think we should interview. Having to have this shit that is over 40 odd years, it's wow, I'm telling you, wow, 41 years old t-shirt, and it's amazing to see.
Well, I'm just learning, Milia, it's that this was one of the guys with others who carried a coffin when Labour Party had won, and they said Freedom Party is dead or something. So the Freedom Party is dead on the coffin. But I'm trying to make out the person.
41-year-old t-shirt.
Yes, I can't make out the guy. Yes, but he's carrying this shirt. You can see it has gone through a lot of washings. You know, it has changed colors somewhat, but you can still make out the print.
Yes,
you can still make out the print, and it says
PJ at the back.
Cecil, can you make out who this is? He looks very familiar, but I don't want to say, because I tell you, when people have masks,
Zappa.
Zappa. Okay.
And
do you know his name?
I don't know his name. I only know him as Zappa.
Okay, so
that
Zappa
was a stalwart of Patrick John.
Wow.
And to have that shirt today, way back in 1980,
oh my goodness,
when Patrick ran for the Roseau Northern constituency, it says a lot, sir.
Yes, it says a lot. It says so much.
And
wow.
I just see Sergeant.
Imagine that.
Sergeant.
It looks like something he.
Sergeant Francois. Had the look on.
Yeah.
Another officer, Corporal.
Okay.
I'm trying to remember his name, but it's another police officer looking on. And really, this one stunned me.
The highlights of this morning.
Oh, yes. You saw it? Yes, I took a photo.
Was it red? It's
red.
Not pink.
No, it's red.
Wasn't
a
red shirt
red
before.
I mean, it's so long, it looks as if it's pink. But it's red.
Okay.
You know?
Right.
Yeah, it's, remember, it's an old shirt washed.
Is
and yeah. I think I'm going to ask this guy to give me that shirt.
Cecily, you should have people, you should have him on Discoveries.
Oh, yes, that's an amazing, amazing sight. I mean, I'm sure that persons who saw it must have been elated. I mean, Zappa with Patrick John, PJ shirt.
Yeah, both PJ.
PJ with the shoe. Oh, my God, and I can imagine Patrick opening his eyes here now and saying, Zappa?
Upafeb.
We still need Sajodia. And I wonder who else, you know. It says quite a lot, volumes, of the man Zappa. Vought Patrick John, man. And I mean, Vought PJ. Big, you know. I mean, I'm going to take this and send that around the world. I mean, that shirt is 41 years old.
Wow.
41 years old, and he's going out of on his bicycle.
Cecily, I love this music. Who's playing this again? I'm trying to remember. Insolence, oh wow, I love this. This is relaxing.
It was in a grip.
It must have been
in a grip.
Yeah. You know?
There's a kind of calm right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the wind is blowing.
Yes, and the weather.
You know, the weather
there's changed
some dark
somewhat.
Clouds hovering, but you know, no immediate threat of rain, you know. Nice ambience. I love this. Really love this, you know. At the Windsor Park Sports Stadium. And whilst we speak, we have the antigen test being done, you know, vaccination as well, not too far, in fact, in that very, you know, expanse of land, in that very area where the body of Patrick John is being exposed for public viewing.
And you know what's interesting, Ivona, while we are here, we have some other family members underneath the tent, and they are among themselves. And I think what triggered this conversation that's going on right now is the same shirt Zappa was wearing.
Okay,
so it triggered a conversation.
Zappa
so
got his moments of fame, I tell you. Zappa is it.
So I'm listening to them, but I'm trying to hear what they're saying, and they're just talking about, you know, the Times election in those years. And, you know, it's nice to see that the family is having that type of conversation even now. In that particular moment.
Yeah.
You know?
So, in periods like that, you need, you know, to talk about other things as well, remember things, you know, and laugh, you know, whether, of course, it's hard. And the music has just ended, and another song is coming up. Gentle breeze blowing, people are coming in. And here comes Grams Morgan again. That
something
song,
about that song, that is song, just, that song. Know, it's just quite fitting for times like this.
I tell you, tell you.
Can you imagine, Ivona, that I just from speaking to one of the survivors still of 1975 who have been involved in politics? And that is Eden Bowers.
Okay, wow.
So, as we said earlier on, so we have Eden Bowers. This Etienne Jenkeman, Etienne, Eden Bowers, Oliver Seraphine, Patrick John is gone, Lennox Honeychurch.
Okay, so Cecil, here comes
Roy.
Roy.
Sweet Roy, we normally call him from Bath State.
Yes,
his mother, also very close, as I was saying earlier on, to about the Frederick sisters. Well, that's Roy, who would have known Patrick John personally as a young boy himself growing up. With Patrick visiting his home, visiting his mom's and adopted father's home, you know, paying his last respect. And I can imagine how Roy feels at that time.
So, Cecil, I really love this. Do we set up shop here? Do we go for it? Of course, we have news coming up. We have news coming at 1:15. But, it's you know, it's
at
really
at
nice
1:15.
You know, to be outside of the studio and doing this, which is so very important, you know. Yeah. So Sweet Roy has
Was literally talking or saying a prayer. Because he made the sign of the cross before he left.
People do different things. You know,
yes, and I see he's crying. Yes. You could see that. I know I told you he was very close to you. Now we're seeing Sir Joseph. Sir Joseph, yes, I remember.
Joseph?
Charles Joseph.
Charles.
No, we call him Sir Charles, but Charles Joseph, you know. His mom too was very close to Patrick John, lived in Kings Hill.
And I think they attended the same church, was it? Anglican church?
I'm not so sure. That one I don't know, but I'm for sure know that the mom of Charles Joseph.
Well, I don't know if I spoke too quickly, because I said already a short while ago there was no immediate threat of rain. There's a slight drizzle though, so I hope that was a premonition, you know.
Yes.
But Sir Charles is not making his way to the exit, and here comes someone else. I'm trying to make this person out, Cecil. Can you make her out, Cecil?
No, can't, for sure.
Am I losing my eyesight or something?
No, you're not. It's just that there's some persons that we will not know, you know? Yeah.
Yes, William.
I'm just seeing Mavis Williams. She worked at the 8 Bank, and I'm sure that she would have been employed in those days by Patrick John. So she came and paid her last respect. You can see her solemn look towards Patrick John. It says quite a lot in terms of her relationship with Patrick.
I worked with Patrick John closely as well when I was doing sports, of course. You know, when I started at DBS Radio, I started on the sports desk. So, you know, I would have a lot, you know, of interactions with Patrick John.
Young Coffee is looking on. I know that his father himself from River Civic would have been close with the man Patrick.
Yeah.
So he just came and paid his last respect to Patrick John, and he's just made his way out.
When your day is down there through, there's a place up there waiting for you. And the music continues. The rain is coming. Why did I say what I just said? I want no immediate threat of rain.
We're a broadcaster, not a forecaster.
Right. That's it, Millie. That's it. Let me also say good afternoon to our technicians on duty. They are really hard at work, you know, ensuring that things go well. Dean Thomas, Derrickson Baptiste, and also Denzel Schillingford, ensuring that we are well taken care of, not just with the mics and the headphones, but with some thoracic lubrication as well. And we are well pleased for that.
You know, Ivona, because of the fall of Patrick in 1979, we saw in 1980 quite a number of political parties came on the scene. We had the Dominican Liberation Movement, the Alliance, and the political leader at the time was Upperton Martin. And the symbol was the hammer. I want us to remember that. And the Freedom Party, led by Dame Eugenia Charles, they won the election in 1980, the symbol, the hand. We had what was called the Caribbean Federation Party, I'm sure you will not be able to remember that.
No,
part at all.
I don't.
The leader at the
that
time was Christian David.
Okay.
And the symbol, the bottle. And you had the Dominican Labour Party. And the leader at the time in 1980 was Patrick Roland John. The symbol, the shoe. And you had the Democratic Labour Party. And the political leader at the time was Oliver J. Seraphine. Symbol the hat.
Okay. So,
five parties in
1980. I know what I can we can get Cecil for his Christmas present. A case of books, exercise books, Canpad exercise books.
Maybe something more electronic, you know. Well,
it's Cecil is old school. Cecil will do. He'll do well with his exercise books. He'll do well. Yeah. Many Rivers to Cross being sung now by Jimmy Cliff.
And it should also be said that while there were five political parties, but there were four major political parties, and in 1980's election, five independent candidates contested. Can you imagine five independent candidates? And all of the five, there were two guys who won.
In
1980.
Was that the year Marcelin Labad went up, was it? No?
Marcelin Labad went up, yes. No, not in 1980. Okay. Marcelin Labad went up in 1970. 1970.
In 1970 only?
Yes, against Patrick John.
But he would have done a lot after
and
that,
his,
right?
His symbol was a clock.
Why do I remember him?
The time will tell. His symbol was a clock.
Okay, a lot of rain now.
Yes.
Wow, it is heavy now. It is heavy, but we are well covered.
It's a passing cloud, nonetheless.
We are well covered. We are under tents, so we are, you know, we are okay. Cecil, I also remember, as we were talking, you know, Rawlings Jemot, so let me just say good afternoon to him. My very good friend, Rawlings Jemot, is another one who would have given me a lot of history. I tell you, just speaking to Rawlings Jemot and my other good friend, Mr. Nicholas. Is it Nicholas of the...
Mr. Nicholas. Bernard Nicholas.
Bernard Nicholas, my very good friend as well. They too would have given me a lot, you know, of history, a lot of data I too have in my head. And there's another changing of the guards, is it, Milia?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Yes. All right. Can imagine standing there for such a long time.
Yes. It's not easy.
And you see,
I see Maurice Cyril coming.
Yes, your good friend.
Yes.
And in those days, Maurice Cyril worked at what newspaper?
At the Chronicle. Was it The Chronicle or Chronicle?
Chronicle.
Chronicle, right.
All right.
Is that it was added?
And the Chronicle was anti that of Patrick John, if you remember, in those days. You know, so Morris would have written quite a lot about Patrick John.
I tell you, broadcasters in these days, they were the professed it, eh?
Yes.
They would do a lot of research and they would cause governments to change, you know,
yes.
And do what they had to do. So Morris Cyril came from that era, from that milieu of broadcasters. So yes, he's here now to pay his last respects.
And before Morris Cyril, I'm thinking I've seen someone. Is it that Dave Corriott?
I can't
Dave
make
Corriott?
Out. From
yeah,
my vantage point.
Don Corriott.
Don
Corriott.
I had a good friend,
yes.
Don Corriott, yes.
Yeah, Don Corriott. And he saluted him.
And he has saluted.
Actually.
That's nice.
That says,
nice.
Says a lot in terms of the relationship.
Yes.
You know?
Yes, comrade.
Yes, salute comrade. Yes. I'm very proud to see someone did that, you know.
Yeah.
He's now going to the family. And
yeah. Wow. So a lot of rain right now, but it does not hinder anything. I guess it will just prevent people from coming right now. But it looks like it will subside, you know, in a while. It's not the kind of rain that tells you that I'm going to be there for a very, very long time. So let's hope not. I'm not a forecaster, I'm a broadcaster, so don't even pay me no mind. So Maurice Cyril now is making his way out. As the music continues, as the people come in slowly, Maurice Cyril, of course, sports journalist, has done so much, you know, in terms of documenting sports.
Yes.
And as I say that, Cecil, Maurice Cyril, I also am think of Allington James as well, you
my
know.
Cousin.
Who has done a lot,
yes,
you know,
yeah.
Not a spring chicken, you know, right now, you know. And I promise Allington, you know, that, you know, I'll have him on, you know, because there's a lot that I want to speak to him
photos.
About, you know, and to document as
yes.
well. You know, about forestry, about the photos that he has taken, because he too has a lot of photos.
Yes.
And about his role, you know, in sports as well, you know, sports journalism. So more people are coming slowly. But we have seen a lot of people here already, and it's really moving in an orderly
and we have to remember too, as I was saying earlier on in 1980 when Patrick Rann,
more history,
Patrick Rann,
I'm listening.
Freedom Party won the election, and the Freedom Party, I could see, won Casimir's constituency with Mr. Sanderson, Collio, with Mr. Alvin Amantredin. I remember Alvin Amantredin as a young boy, you know, really fighting. With the Dominican Freedom Party, Cottage constituency with Mr. Alan Cabon, who was then Minister for Communication and Works for a number of years, and he represented Cottage constituency, Granby, Juliana Henderson, La Plaine, Hesketh Alexander, Maho, Brian Allen, Marigot, Pat Stevens,
I remember him so well.
Pitit Savan, Fidel, Ralph Fidel, Rosa Central, uh-huh. Mary Eugenia Charles, Rosa North, Henry Dyer, Rosa South, Ronan David, Rosa Valley, Henry George, Salisbury, Denison John, Soufriere, Anthony Moyes, St. Joseph Caleb Laura, Vieques, Alexis Williams, and Wesley Kenneth Williams. These were the people in 1980. 17 out of 21 won the election. And as I said, there were two independent candidates who won in the people of Conrad Cyrus of Mont Jean River Syrie and Pebush Jenna Amo on the booth.
So you mentioned a lot of names, you know, and I had the opportunity to interact, you know, with a lot of them. And I say thanks for broadcasting, you know, because Milia too, I'm sure that you will realize that, you know, you have come to know a lot of people because of your career that, you know, that you are in right now, you know, in broadcasting. Because Cecil mentioned a lot of names, you know.
Because even in these names, a lot of these people. Too, I think a few of them form part of a program which we once had, produced by Daryl Tit. Where are they now?
And so, in fact, just recently, you know, Daryl and I were talking about this, trying to bring this back. But we even have our ideas at DBS Radio to do these things. As you know, we have had a lot of discussions, you know, about these things, and we really have to work on it steadfastly. We have to do it right now. We have to.
And we would remember even too in that general election in 1980, the Democratic Labour Party was also successful. At that time, remember Patrick John had fired Michael Douglas, so he ran for the OG. Democratic Labour Party, and so Michael Douglas and Portsmouth won that constituency, and the Salibier constituency by Matthew Joseph of the Kalinago Territory. So that says, in terms of the landscape of Dominica politics in 1980, when Patrick actually ran as the leader of the Dominica Labour Party, and I think that was the last time that he ran as a leader, because after that, you know, you found that Babs Dyer, Oliver Seraphin and Mike Douglas, all of them became one within the Dominica Labour Party, the space of the Dominica Labour Party. And so when we ran in 1985, Michael Douglas was now then the leader of the Dominica Labour Party until 1990, on his passing.
The late, his brother, Rosie Michael Douglas, came. Douglas, of course, Rosie Douglas, you know, died, of course, in office as a prime minister, so we also have to bring his name, you know, in that discussion. And as we speak, if you're just tuning in though and you're wondering what is happening, just to say, as you have been saying, we are at the Windsor Park Stadium for the final viewing, the public viewing of the late former premier of Dominica, Patrick Roland John. And this goes up until 2 o'clock this afternoon today. DBS Radio, of course, we will stop our broadcast in a while because we have to make way for the news and the announcements. But we continue to do this as people come in and pay their last respects to Patrick John. You may be hearing a lot of other names and some other discussions as well. But it's obvious that when you speak about Patrick John, a lot of names and other discussions will have to come into the fray. So that is why we are taking this opportunity as well to bring in some, you know, historical data, because that too is important.
Even okay, do que choy avuna usaf pis tale no keni pou fini. Occasion sa la jodi a, c'est pas seulement pour nous ça mener ou ça va ben pour présenter public là qui a écouté ou sa situation qui nous a exposé caravli, mais encore c'est une opportunité pour moun ça apprendre pour moun qui pas te savent ça éduquer quoi aujourd'hui à quoi ça contribution ben nous capable quoi contribution à situation Patrick John, c'est pas des yo quelque contribution, c'est contribution tout partout à tout aspect, comme on dit, comme ça c'est une opportunité pour nous ça apprendre si bien plus contre lui et moi te que les qui conduit à l'air peut-être ni au monument, mais peut-être plus que ça, puisque Patrick John, enfin, un petit temps qui était en politique, c'était il fait un patché. Avec mon quoi qui peut-être, mon mentionné, ça c'est un peu plus bonnet, mais il était bien pour nous savoir un museum. Odomnik, Ospedata Wozo, FFPC, Lautan Listwem Copatrician, but to tell no one kiss a still ni, a queer so as so on live la, a poor portrait Simontala, Pusafa, no Pujan Jean, ni opportunity to connect Simon Lakite, give a telma contribution, c'est pas seulement pour nous, pour t'en know you a passant, mais pour ça, where you ever documented Simontala qui fait a contribution. Cosa Jodia pour moi était plus qui en exposition caraf, mais pour moi, une opportunité pour apprendre pile dot. Hot sa mou deja konet, pou mwen mou deja mou de konet Patrick John, ko moun la ki jwen kon pa pou ene Dominik vini ene depora, men mou vini konet ti pou pli kot Patrick John eve mou ka pou esye l'histoire ki Mr. Joseph, the historian jodi ya, opportunity ya pou posante tout sa ite sa posante epi Patrick John mou ka mou vini mou apwese sa jodi ya.
You see, I think also to Ivona, it is of great importance that we know our history, because if we don't know our history, we won't know where we are going. And I think there are a number
of
people.
You know what, the people without the knowledge of your history, what happens after?
Right, you know, we don't want to perish. And I'm saying that it's important that generations to come should know, will know,
and
if we are given the opportunity to exhibit the contribution that they have made. So I think,
and I really believe as well that while the past should not be a place of residence, it is a wonderful place of reference.
Of reference.
So you have to go back to the past if you want to shape the future.
So I'm saying that I think government should now look at putting together a place where we can recognize the work of our great people. We have had Sissy Kredera, who has done so much for culture and the arts. We have, if Mr. Bully passed tomorrow morning, who will know about him in the next 20 years? Presently, we have the Prime Minister of Dominica, who has been doing so much for Dominica. When he passed, generations to come should know, so we could have a place of reference. And I'm saying that it is high time that we look at a hero park, a park of our heroes.
I agree.
A place, a museum for our heroes, so that when people from outside of Dominica,
a hero square,
something
we need that.
That's of great importance to us in Dominica, because we have so many people who have done so much for us. I mean, we people say, oh, you don't know about Jim Reeves. I mean, it's no fault of nobody, because we have nothing to talk about. We don't have them in.
But I know a lot about him.
No, it's a her.
No, it's a her. The writer.
It's a her.
The writer.
Jean Reeves. And luckily for us, or fortunately, we have documented some of her work as well.
Yes. Right.
We have this as part of the 100 Great Dominicans production.
Yeah. Tomorrow, who knows? The other persons who have done so much to Dominica, Dame Eugenia Charles. I mean, present generation who are 21 years old may not even know who is Dame Eugenia Charles. And I think it's high time that we do these things.
I remember when you and I were talking about that very thing, you know, about documenting people's lives, you know. I mean, when you look at the contribution that people like Toby Chilinford has made, you know, Cecil, not just in cricket.
Yes.
Because what cricket did for him, it pushed Dominica, you know, Irving Chilinford, you know, and the others, Norbert
Phillips,
you know, and you could go on and on and on. So there are so many people, and sometimes we pass them on the road, you know, and we just pass them straight, and we don't realize that these are the people who laid the foundation for us.
It is sickening to note that Ophelia, Lady of Song, we all say Lady of Song. What if tomorrow morning that Ophelia goes, what happens in the next 20 years, two generations later, that no one will remember who Ophelia was actually is? And I think we need to lament this. We need to call on the Ministry of Culture, central government, to look at the importance of people's contribution. On 4th of November, yes, we do that, where we contribute, or we have recognized persons who have contributed. But I'm saying, out of the political landscape, we have to now look at people who have contributed in all sorts of manner, not just political.
And even just recently, as we celebrated or we observed Centenarians Day, currently having 23, but we would have seen so many gone before, those who are living still. So even they too, because you can imagine the foundation. That, yes, we are celebrating Patrick John's lives, but they too, the centenarians, would have done so much in their own way. So I would like to advocate, you know, for, you know, a museum, something of that sort that would, you know. And a lot of times I always say, people, it's still in us that we learn from pictures, and people, you know, we would have portraits of the ones who would have towards the contribution they would have made to enable us to enjoy the society that we're living in today. So I am an advocate for that, and I would like to see that. And Mr. Joseph mentioned call on the Ministry of Culture, local government, and all of that stuff. But it's something that is worth looking into and something I would like to see become a reality.
So I'm looking at the time now. We don't have much time. I think we have about three minutes. We don't have time. About 3 minutes because we have to go back to studio, you know, to continue with our normal programming. Well, that is part of our normal programming. As I said, this is very important for us, Cecil.
And even when we decided to have planned this thing today, we didn't think that was going to go for this long time.
Never did I imagine I remember that I would have spoken
one,
so much.
Said 1 hour, and I'm like, I've wondered the amount of information that there is to talk about, that we could go beyond 1 hour. And I'm happy that we were able to really contribute towards, you know, enlightening people as to the work of what Patrick John is able to do and to bring to the fore. And so he's another Caribbean leader who has passed, one of the old guards of the early days of the 70s. As I said, he must have been one of the last to go. We know Fairbird has died a good time ago. We know that John Compton, Milton Keynes, Eric Williams, also Bradshaw,
Burnham,
Forbes Burnham in Guyana. You know, when we look at all of these people in those days, you know, they're all gone, you know.
Yeah.
Even the man who gave us a reach for independence, James Callaghan, himself, you know, Prime Minister of England at the time, he's gone. So Patrick John must be one of the standing ones prior to
he having partied of
course. He partied on the 6th of June.
Of July.
Mm-hmm. So it says quite a lot, you know, of the work that Patrick John has done, and I'm happy that us at DBS Radio were able to stand tall with him, mm-hmm. and others. I'm sure we may not be there tomorrow, but we will be there for sure to do whatever is taken of us to do.
Definitely.
And soon from now, I'm sure there will be something for Edward Regis.
Edward Regis, of course.
Who has passed, and Edward Regis, who has done his fair share as a young man in the National Youth Council and also as parliamentary representative of the Grandi constituency, and has done quite a lot for young people in the Caribbean.
Definitely.
So we will be on top of the action, and I'm happy that we were able to bring this live to the general public.
Yes, definitely. I'm very happy, and so happy that, you know, we could really bring this, but not just tell you about the casket that is open for viewing, you know, not just to tell you about the people that are coming here, you know, to view the body, but to tell you about what is also important to us as a people, you know, of a small island developing state, you know, and having realized that we have grappled with so much, but we remain resilient, and we realize the importance of things like that, about documenting history and, you know, documenting these things, you know, in terms of posterity. And we are happy that we have a team at DBS Radio that can come together and work on things like that. Cecil, yes?
Former Prime Minister, Mr. James.
Okay. Trying to remember his name, his first name.
I'm trying to remember his first name too.
Can you remember his first name? Okay, Amelia?
Right.
Chigan James, yes.
Uh-huh. The son of Edison James, yeah. Former Prime Minister. He's just showing his last respect. It's important that from all circles that we need to recognize the efforts of that of Patrick John.
Yeah.
I mean, the next hour, for sure, he'll be taken back to Lynhurst, where they'll be preparing again for tomorrow.
Yeah.
Tomorrow morning, I think. It's 10 o'clock.
It's 10 o'clock tomorrow.
We have now with us nurse.
She lives on Cox Street. I'm trying to remember her last name.
Very
popular nurse,
yes.
You know. Very jovial, approachable,
very nice
person.
You know, yes.
I think she is the sister of, and I can't even remember his name
yes,
as
his
well.
Name,
but
yes,
Collier. Right,
Nurse Collier.
Nurse Collier. Yes. All right. So that's it from us, Milia. So I'm sure you want to say something in Creole.
We are comedy as. Exposition Caravla, mais c'était un moment historique pour moi, mais mon peut-être. C'est un peu fait un pays. Mes discussions sont là. Historique, comme ça. Si vous montez ça là, parmi Zodia, enfin, c'est célébré. Nous qui voyons encore demain si je l'ai vu nous trouver Patrick John avec et puis à présent Ed Regis.
Just want to thank our technical team today for ensuring that we're both live on video and audio. so that our listeners and viewers can actually see what actually happened today. And right now, we are almost saying bye-bye to the...
But even as you recognize the work of the technicians and ensuring that we are live on both audio and on the internet, on the radio and on the internet, we also have to thank, you know, the DBS team as well. We just have received some food packages. So let me say as well, thanks to the manager's secretary, Gail Sensi, and also to the accountant, you know, Mr. Jefferson Carbon, who, you know, listened to us, you know, and realized that apart from having a good broadcast, there are some things that we need as well. So we have to say thanks.
And so we came here to recognize the life of a man who born in 1948, 7th of January, and passed on the 6th of July, 2021, 83 years of age. And so as we recognize his life, here at DBS Radio, we want to ensure you that we will continue doing all necessary by informing and educating the general public, not only of Patrick John, but of many other great leaders in Dominica and persons who have contributed solely to the works of what these people have been able to do for Dominica. And as you heard from the Prime Minister yesterday, that Patrick John himself was able to help in the development of Dominica's landscape. And so our job as broadcasters is to inform and educate our general public of the things that people of Dominica have been able to do for our beautiful country, Dominica. And from me...
Yes, even as we end, I see someone coming. It looks like your co-host, you know, on Discoveries.
Oh,
my
yes,
good friend, Francis Richard
Major.
And he, too, has a lot, you know, of history, especially when it comes
photos.
To... Photos, right. Yes.
Yes.
And, yes.
And we may take the last person, Francis Richards. What was good about today is in reference to the protocol. The health protocol, all observed, you know. We heard earlier on 10, but we did not see 10 people. We saw them coming in one by one by one. And it, for me, was a very solemn moment just to observe the way that people actually came in. And if you were able to see and view on our social media, you would have been able to see exactly what type of arrangement, beautiful arrangement that was actually done. And if we know Francis well, he would have taken pictures before he would have actually gone to his last minute. And we have seen, you know, seen the son of Mr. John, you know, maybe going to do, maybe going to Francis Richards, so maybe have a word with him. But, you know, today it was a really good day for us, Ivona, to really inform and to educate the general public.
Yes, Cecil, it was really nice working with you and Amelia Joseph Dennis. I learned a lot myself, you know. These broadcasts really empower me, you know, and really motivate me to do more. We are happy that we could bring this live to you. We'll be at it again tomorrow.
That is the son of Patrick John. That is Junior.
That's the one you took
for Yes, Nairi for Nairi.
But he looks like Nairi.
Yes, that's Junior. Yes, Junior. Yeah. Oh, my God. How could I forget that?
So, yes.
He just moved and walked across, and I just realized that is Junior.
Okay. All right.
Junior.
So,
yes, that's,
so that's it.
First of his wife.
All right. So, that's it for us at the Windsor Park Stadium.
And also, we want to say thank you to Flo Dominica.
For
giving us a beautiful tent, a 10x10 tent,
and what a shelter
at short notice, to give us this 10x10 tent, yeah, to so we could do this broadcast. And thank God we had done that, because the rain would have maybe end us abruptly. And we just want to say thank you to Flo for their contribution, and to DBS Radio, and also for the internet line. And I must say, Flo, that you have been a partner always with DBS Radio, and I just want to say, as manager and as broadcaster here today, thank you very much for helping us to make this broadcast a possible one, to make it be the what it was in terms of its quality and the kind of broadcast that you're able to bring to all listeners, Ivona.
All right, Cecil, thank you so much, you know, for tuning in to DBS Radio. Keep it locked. There's a lot coming in store. Of course, we have news coming up at 1:15, then we have the lotto draw, and then the announcements. And there's so much more today. It's Tuesday. Good afternoon. On behalf of all of us, it was a pleasure. Back to Studio One.
Oh, that was good. Very, very good. That was good.